Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Well, it's all going according to the globalist plan, unfortunately. But humanity is speaking out and resisting. Ladies and gentlemen, it is the 12th day of September 2011. CNN is running the headline that there are peace treaty deals being pushed with al-Qaeda. So they're now shifting from saying that the American people need to give their rights up because of al-Qaeda hiding in everyone's underwear, and the TSA has to, you know, go in there immediately and has to set up highway checkpoints to al-Qaeda is good and the American people are the terrorists. That is the new official, well, they say Christians, gun owners, returning veterans, number one enemy. You're not tuning into a Twilight Zone. Listeners of talk radio know this has been big news the last few years. We're actually saying this on air. It's actually admitted. This is the craziness. And the power structure doesn't care. They're just going ahead with it. Mothers all over the country are being arrested if their children play in a cul-de-sac on bicycles or scooters. CPS is taking them. They're hitting them hard. That's out of Houston, reporting it like it's a good thing. They are forcing inoculations in the Western world. Cameras are going in bathrooms in Europe, England, and the U.S., including in the girls' showers. I've got mainstream news on that today. Off the chart insanity. Here's CNN exclusive. Al-Qaeda leader's brother offers peace plan. This is part of the rehabilitation of al-Qaeda, who the globalists have always run. That said, we told you the clash of civilizations was coming and that they would put al-Qaeda in charge in Libya, Syria, and basically all over Africa, and they would start blowing everything up. That has now begun. Protesters are attacking U.S. diplomatic compounds in Egypt, Libya, and this just in Afghanistan. Of course, U.S. ambassador to Libya, absolutely machine gunned with two of his CIA compadres and drug around by their al-Qaeda dogs. And that's what you get. I mean, you went and put al-Qaeda in to line up the black Libyans and kill 40,000 of them with pleasure, throw them off roofs, chop their heads off, murder Christians with pleasure. There weren't any Jews to speak of in Libya. And just kind of have it as cutesy in the news. Oh, look at the, Mr. CIA Anderson Cooper out there praising them. Hey, Anderson, you little cowardly CIA piece of trash. You globalist banker front man to bring this country down. Why don't you, because the CIA works for foreign banks, not this country. Today it cannot be debated. Why don't you go over there and play footsie with your al-Qaeda now? And they're going to have their cake and eat it too. They're now, of course, in the army manuals that we told you about years ago from my sources. It's now declassified, saying that the Tea Party is going to link up with al-Qaeda. Remember that a month ago or 3 weeks ago? People are like, Alex, how did you know this? Well, I have sources. They train the police in all intelligence groups, not the general cops, but in all the intelligence, police intelligence, state police, federal intelligence, that patriots, anti-globalists will link up with al-Qaeda. I mean, that's like saying Superman's going to link up with Lex Luthor. It's totally ridiculous. But they don't care. They'll blow stuff up and blame it on us. They might come arrest me and say I work for al-Qaeda, because I don't, because I know who al-Qaeda really works for. Al-Qaeda is just something where they come take your house, put you in a camp, take your business, stick their hands down your pants, whatever the case is, to dominate you. They say, well, I'm doing it because of al-Qaeda. We're like, but you run al-Qaeda. Shut up. Shut up, al-Qaeda. We're like, but you actually fund them. Shut up, al-Qaeda. It's like saying you're a witch or something and they're going to burn you at the stake just because they want your property. Witch, witch, she's a witch. Well, how do we know she's a witch? Well, we throw in the water, and if she drowns, she's innocent. But if she floats, she's a witch. Then we burn her at the stake. Witch, witch, witch. Either way, you die. But then the real global crime syndicate is right there in front of everybody. The bedlam is becoming to break loose. Incredible economic news. Global meltdowns, QE3, it's all on the table, straight ahead. This is history in the making. Stay with us. Well, I'm I am here to tell you, my friends, that if you are just joining us here for the first time, this is a very important radio transmission that you are not going to want to miss on this Wednesday, 12th day of September, 2012. You have found it, the tip of the spear, the front lines in the global fight against the private banking cartels that fund and run al-Qaeda, that fund and run the major mafias of the globe, and that control the issuance of currency and credit, and who are openly attempting to establish a private corporate world government where you will face scan and hand scan to buy and sell. I know you've heard about that in a book written thousands of years ago, but regardless of whether you believe in the Bible or not, this is what they're attempting to set up. So look out, because their religion is eugenics. You know it today as transhumanism. They believe that they are forcibly taking control of human development. They call it evolution, and have decided that the majority of us will be exterminated once the global digital skin is in place. Once all the smart meters, all the controlled appliances, once the smart dust is in place, once they have combat robots on every street corner, they will begin releasing bioweapons, wiping out large portions of the world. They will pose as saviors, blaming terrorists when they do this, and then corralling the survivors into more and more compact cities, killing us in phases. I have reverse engineered their entire program. Most of it is declassified in public because they're so arrogant they openly discuss their plans. I would say over 90% of what I just stated is on record. The rest is my reverse engineering, which has been proven to be frighteningly accurate. Again, I'm going to explain this to you. We are in a red level species emergency. Red level species emergency. The species is being gelded, being domesticated, being dumbed down in preparation for what Dick Cheney called for in the September 20th, 2000, Rebuilding America's Defenses. The use of race-specific bioweapons to first begin wiping out certain ethnic groups. Again, ladies and gentlemen, we are at a red level point. Unfortunately, my analysis of more than a decade ago, when I really clicked on their current program and really got the big picture, the first to really reverse engineer it to this level. I'm not bragging. It's just that I was the first to really click to it. Unfortunately, now we're so deep into this, it's all been confirmed, and it's worse than I thought even. So I wish I could tell you it was that I was wrong and that I overestimated them. I underestimated. They're going ahead with the program. They're going ahead with the program. You're not listening to science fiction here. You're listening to the real world. We told you they would hand the Middle East over to al-Qaeda years ago. We told you they would then start a war with al-Qaeda, doubling back, while the master al-Qaeda controllers send their jihadis out to be killed. In fact, I'm going to break down how this deal really works here in just a moment, and then I want to start laying out where the globalists are going to take us. Now, that said, we have Dinesh D'Souza, former Reagan administration official, best-selling author. And, of course, he has one of the top films in the country in the last 3 weeks, Obama's America 2012, or Obama's America 2016, what it would look like if he stayed in power. Again, we're teleprompter-free news here. I don't go off notes, so I occasionally butcher information. But we are going to have him on, the writer and director of 2016 Obama's America. And we're going to be having him on the show at the start of the next hour. Then we have retired top NBA star Theo Ratliff joining us with Dr. Wallach to talk about what true supplementation did for him, because this is one of the biggest secrets out there the globalists don't want you to be aware of. So we look forward to that. And then we'll also be opening the phones up on the state of the world here. But if you're a new listener and you hear me, you know, ranting and raving about how they're going to exterminate everyone, you need to understand, ladies and gentlemen, there have been thousands of covert operations declassified, and in some cases, one operation out of thousands killed thousands. And I've listed off things you can write down and then search engine them and find it for yourself. Over 4,000 U.S. foster children radiated to death in the 40s, 50s, and 60s by the Department of Energy. Department of Defense. I mean, they took little kids and put them in chambers and fried them. And it wasn't to test what radiation did. They could do that with other mammals. They knew what it would do. It was to test and create a culture of absolute mass murder and death. They then had Israel prove their worthiness to the New World Order to irradiate 110,000 plus of their children. That's declassified, ringworm children. China delivered the greatest sacrifices, aborting hundreds of millions in the last 30 years or so. Also killing 85 million, 84 million, the numbers vary. Chinese history, CIA says 60 plus million of their people. They were put in power by the Rothschilds and Rockefellers. Chiang Kai-shek was shut down. This has now been declassified. Old-timers told me about it when I first got on air, but it was only rumors then and anecdotal evidence. It was declassified a few years ago. It's even on History Channel that the CIA in 1949 didn't put Mao Zedong in. They also helped put Pol Pot in to kill 30% of the population, to wipe out the Cambodian intelligentsia. So they'll use fascists, they'll use Khmer Rouge, they'll use communists. As Carol Quigley said, they'll use anybody. This is about absolute maximum power. And they will use the Muslim extremist to jihad and take over, and then use the fear of that to take over our lives. So you have to understand that. We are in the grip of the most sinister, scientifically focused evil the world has ever seen. And only full awakening to it will give us any chance to stop it. Now, let me just give you a smattering of the headlines here, okay? U.S. ambassador to Libya killed, drugged to the streets, Muammar Gaddafi style, by al-Qaeda that our criminal government put in charge there. And they think you're so stupid now, they're saying, oh, yes, horrible al-Qaeda, and not pointing out they put them in. New DARPA robot can autonomously track and kill people. LS3 robot put out by the big defense contractors, they're rolling them all out. And again, they're not going to send out SWAT teams to try to hunt you down if you've evaded you and your family being picked up to be brought to the FEMA reeducation and, extermination center. They're not going to be doing that. They're going to send out hunter-killer robots on you. So be made aware of that. I was told that by a Marine Corps colonel 14 years ago. And I told you about hunter-killer robots. Now they're starting to bring them out and show them to you because they're getting ready to put them on the streets. Japan is already putting sentinel robots on the streets. Foxconn, that runs the slave factories for Al Gore and Apple, now is enforcing one-child policy, forced abortions. That's mainstream news today. They are now having sentinel robots installed to oversee the slave labor. So we're now entering hell grid, and they're going to use China and the hell they've created as an economic implosion point, a black hole, to make everybody compete with that to pull humanity down to slave level. Globalism isn't to empower, it's to enslave. It's the race to the bottom. But Al Gore on Larry King Live looked at Ross Perot and said, "That's ridiculous, Ross. Larry, this is a good deal." When they send Agenda 21 to your local town and call it sustainability, it's all, "Hi, we've got free federal money. We're going to build your town up." And they're buying off your local mayors and people and promising them deals. Oh, yes, all over Austin. All over Austin. We've sent our reporters out. We've got a report coming up later in the week, whether it's Dripping Springs or whether it's Elgin, wherever it is. They're going to build these buildings and subsidize. You'll only be able to afford living in them. And there'll be a factory in the building you work at, and you don't leave the building. Yeah. It's all coming. And when they shut the fuel off and shut the electricity off, make you pay 10 times for it, you're going to have to go live in their little organized areas where they subsidize. It's basically like Walmart on steroids, like it was meant to deindustrialize everything. Well, this new system is to accelerate that, where the taxes and regulations for everybody else, you fold and are driven into their cities. Just like under Agenda 21, more than 20 years ago, my parents would travel extensively. They shot a lot of amazing video down in Yucatan and into the Rainbow and all those areas down there. And there was all these UN signs, and they would push the natives who've been there for thousands of years off their land, wouldn't let them fish anymore. There'd just be whole cleared out areas. for thousands of square miles. You'd hardly see anyone. I mean, it's like a ghost town, and they drive them all up at gunpoint to Mexico City. So, I mean, it is all on. I mean, just devastating program that we're going to go into right now. This is the re-education. All of America, all of Europe, all the public schools, they are re-education camps with cameras in the bathroom stalls, with Defense Department AI computers tracking how many calories your kids eat, scanning as they eat the calorie calculations, Department of Defense, tracker chips around their necks. Tracking them in the school bus and home. If children go outside, their parents are arrested. Fox News, I'm going to report this. I'm not joking now. You will be arrested. You will stay indoors. You are a prisoner. It's here. It's coming. Breathalyzers in all the cars. Just total control. You want it? You got it. You want to be a slave? You want a nanny state? You got it. Forced inoculations nationwide. You got it. Cancer, you got it, 10,000 percentage plus in children. You can look those numbers up. Some cancers are even higher. Over 10,000% in autism in the last 30 years. 3,000% on average for adults. Sheryl Crow already had breast cancer. She took the chemo and stuff. Now she's got the brain cancer. She's blaming it on the cell phone. Hey, honey, it's all of it. I bet you take your shots, don't you, Sheryl? Well, don't worry. The system you trust, all the women out there getting their Gardasil shots, prepare to die. Because you're under a soft kill operation. You want to die? You want to be murdered by globalists? They're just practicing and seeing how many of us they can kill before we wake up. If you're a new listener and you're like, really, Dick Cheney wrote that they want to use race-specific bioweapons. Yeah, I mean, it was even in my local paper. One of the few papers to decry it was the Austin American Statesman, which is generally a horrible publication, but they actually got it right back when Cheney wrote about that. And the point is, this is what the scientific controllers are into. They see you as dumb animals. And then they set up a culture where they promote the fact that it's cool to be domesticated jellyfish, which becomes a self-fulfilling prophecy. And, I mean, take the troops. They wouldn't let them use DU until 1990, and even then you had to have decontamination. And now they just say, oh, use it, shoot it, be around it, clean your gun, don't even worry about it. It's a death sentence. I mean, you can't get around the fact that a scientific technocratic elite, why have Western governments tested stuff on little kids that they knew would kill them? Why have they done Joseph Mengele-type experiments that make Mengele look like a choir boy, literally? Why did they approve microwave cell phones when the studies in the 70s showed brain tumors in the mice and the monkeys? There's thousands of studies, thousands, hundreds a year come out. Of course it gives you brain cancer. It vibrates the DNA. It breaks the DNA, causing cell mutation. That's in all the studies. And now Sheryl Crow's got a brain tumor. Yeah, how's that for you, rock star? I wish you weren't dying. But I guarantee you she's going to go get her brain chopped up. She's going to do all the stuff and end up dying probably. And she'll be out there, raise money for cancer, raise money for cancer, raise money for treatments instead of find out why, why? In fact, I shouldn't even be attacking her. Try to get her on. She's actually saying the cell phone probably did it. You're right, lady. I'm mad, though. I'm mad for my family. I'm mad that I use cell phones. My wife's always used this hands-free. Plug this in, which is a little bit better. But still, I can't believe I kept wireless out of my house for about a year after I moved. And I suddenly just capitulated and put it in. It's out of my house today. I'm mad at myself. I'm weak. If I sound like I'm mad at Sheryl Crow, I'm not. I'm mad she's dying. Because let me tell you, I don't worry about dying myself. But I tell you, there's something about women in your family. And my son as well. But men are genetically designed to not be as upset about men, other men. I worry about my grandmother. I worry about my mother. I worry about my wife and my daughters. And because they're so innocent and good and sweet and soft. And you just want to protect them. And you know they're under attack. And you know this evil just continues on and on and on and never abates. And I've got all the documents in my film Endgame. Whatistheendgame.com is an online website with the bibliography of the film. Let's put it on screen, please. Whatistheendgame.com or endgamethemovie.com. And it's all the quotes where they say they're going to build a world government, release bioweapons, and kill us. I mean, this is not a game, ladies and gentlemen. The FBI has visited Professor Pianca, who says soon the airborne Ebola will be released and 90% will die and his family's ready. You know, this isn't a game. When he gave a speech at the Texas Academy of Sciences, he got a standing ovation for 3 minutes, it was reported in the news, with the Texas scientist, he gets awards all the world, crying when he projected a full screen of skulls behind him at the PowerPoint presentation. These people are a death cult. They are in control. They're trying to mop up the free internet and what's left of talk radio. You've got to make a full break with these people. You've got to fully listen to me, go check out my claims and find out they're true. Because that's why I'm fearless, because we're walking dead, ladies and gentlemen. There's no future. I'll use the Star Trek analogy because that seems to get through to people, movie analogies. Wrath of Khan. The ship's not going to make it out of there when the weapon gets detonated. Spock knows everybody's dead if they don't go down there and get it fixed. He goes in there and gets radiated. Captain Kirk comes in to open it up, try to save him. And the doctor says he's dead already. That's what you've got to realize, ladies and gentlemen. Most of us are not going to live out our full lives already. We've already been eating GMO. We've already had vaccines. We've already been drinking fluoride. If we would have lived to 100, we're living to 50. We're dead already. It's important to make that decision. I'll use another movie analogy, The Thing. It's blown the generator. In 10 hours, they're all going to be frozen to death. The most important thing is they take that thing out so it doesn't make it to the mainland. Well, we've got a global government run by our own species that see themselves as Morlocks and us as the Eloi. H.G. Wells admitted that was an analogy of the elite versus us. And the Morlocks feed on the Eloi. And they're scientifically advanced. We're not. We're dumb, but we're also virtuous. They're evil and controlling. And we've got to wake up to that and organize now, or there's no future. When I come back, I'm getting into the news. Come hell or high water. This is the GCN Radio Network. GCNLive.com is the website. And I'm Alex Jones of Infowars.com. We're streaming video at PrisonPlanet.tv. You ever heard the saying, truth stranger than fiction? I dare you to look into reality. Ghostbusters clip, because it's, you know, funny to say, hey, you know, war, famine, death, hyperinflation. You wish it was a game. You wish it was a joke. And we lived in a country where we can laugh at the adversity. At least some yuppies do of other nations. And, oh, look at how they live. Civilization is actually very, very hard to continue. It always ends up falling apart because the corrupt get in charge and become delusional and try to exploit the country they control to take over the next nation. And a lot of other factors are involved in that as well. I'm going to get into the news right now ahead of Dinesh D'Souza, maker of Obama's America 2016. I'm very excited about this interview coming up. You know, getting into the, you didn't build it views of Obama, why he would say something like that. And the thesis that D'Souza has, that it's an anti-colonialism idea. And where he says they're going to have the Muslims take over the whole Middle East and spread into Russia, Western Europe, and Africa. But I mean, is it just Obama doing all that, or is it, you know, a lot bigger? Now, what's behind all of that? Here's the type of tech news we've got. New DARPA robot can autonomously track people and kill people. Professor warns machines will be used to kill people. They already have autonomous drones in the air doing it. We've told you this is coming. The next big issue of the magazine coming out, boy, is it powerful. It's going to be covering this. Scientists control rats' dreams with technique that could enhance memory. Oh, with special wavelengths, special flashing lights. Oh, that just so happened to piggyback on the new data transmitting light bulbs. You see, ladies and gentlemen, everything, all this high tech. Tech is fine, but it's being designed to control us. So we're going to be going over that. But first, let's get to the big top story that I've been alluding to. We actually have a photo here at Infowars.com with an excellent article by Tony Cartolucci. We'll put that up on screen. It's in the article, U.S.-backed terrorist murder U.S.-owned ambassador in Libya. And notice right there in the photo to the right, of John McCain is Christopher Stevens, the U.S. ambassador. And they fly the al-Qaeda flag over Benghazi, over Tripoli. That's been in the news. They wear black uniforms with the al-Qaeda flag. They've been given 10,000 missiles, 2,000 plus. That was in the news. But even before it was in the news, I talked to an Air Force officer on the flight back from Las Vegas shooting the show with Ventura last year, the one where they had the coffin on board and he was flying it. And he goes, no, the word is, you're right, it's over 2,000 heat-seeking and radar missiles. The point is that I even confirmed it from him before it was even in the news. I said, it's thousands, isn't it? He goes, yeah, it's about 10,000, over 2,000 guided. The point is, oh, but al-Qaeda might be in your five-year-old daughter's pants. And we need a highway checkpoint randomly in Ohio by the TSA. They just had one last week to just throw stuff out of your car. But al-Qaeda can have 10,000 missiles. 2,000 of them, they just aim them at the aircraft, and it shoots right into the nose cone where they got the radar, or right into the engine. I mean, you can't miss on takeoff or landing. They just pull up by an airport, mile away, fire. And then TSA can dance around and, hey, bring your daughter, bring your son on over here. See, I won't fly with them because of that. And they're like, it don't matter, Jones. Doesn't matter. We're coming to the streets, punk. And TSA-style security. But there it is in the photo. U.S.-backed terrorists murder U.S.'s own ambassador in Libya. And there it is. All admitted. Over a year and a half ago, Webster Tarpley went there. We confirmed al-Qaeda was coming out of Benghazi. They had tanks. They had planes. And the media would run headlines all over the place about how they were heroes, and they were just protesters, and Gaddafi was being mean, and he had rape gangs with Viagra. Rape, of course, that wasn't true. Saddam didn't throw babies out of incubators in Kuwait either. That was later declassified as totally fake. But so what? And then al-Qaeda went in and just lined up tens of thousands of black Africans. You know, they're African. They get to live there, don't they? Just lined them up, because a lot of the Saudi Arabians are incredibly racist towards black people. Just lined them up and just shot them. But sometimes a bullet was too expensive. So there's lots of videos of families begging, and the jihadis have got the machetes, and they just never get tired of hacking people's arms off while they try to protect themselves. Here in America, that'd be called assaulting the al-Qaeda officer. You put your arm up, hack those wrists off, and then just hack into that neck, slabbering blood everywhere, freedom fighting all the way. And now they've been attacking for 9 months in Syria, taking families, and we're going to kill your whole family if you don't drive this suicide bomb into the police station. And then they even go on the news and say, Assad's massacring people. But the videos come out. It's al-Qaeda chopping people's heads off, throwing them off roofs, blowing up churches, murdering people, desecrating the cross. But that's okay, because they're fighting Assad, who's been a stabilizing force and lets the Christians and Jews live there in peace, some of the oldest Christian and Jewish communities in the world outside of Israel. So that's what's really going on, and now it's all admitted. Remember a month ago, CFR said, quote, we need al-Qaeda, and how they're organizing things, how they're the core, and how they're doing a great, and Saudi Arabia is arming them. Good old Saudi Arabia, created by British intelligence over 100 years ago. Lawrence of Arabia, in your face. In your face. And it doesn't matter if they run al-Qaeda. They think you're so stupid. They say the NSA is going to spy on you without warrants. They say that they are going to take your rights, and they're teaching the police, don't worry about al-Qaeda. It's the gun owners, libertarians, conservatives, people that say there's a new world order. As the new world order is being announced. And again, the CFR said al-Qaeda's specter in Syria, but went on to say, quote, we need al-Qaeda. If that's the same article, you guys just type Control-F, we need al-Qaeda. Control-F that, and then it'll show it in the article, where it's like, yeah, they're kind of bad guys, but we need them. We need to use them against the Serbs in the 90s. And then when the Serbs fight back, oh, it's a war crime. We got to bomb your whole country with DU and watch your birth defects explode. And again, they hate the Serbs, they hate the American people, they hate the Muslims. The globalists will play everybody off against each other. You're thinking there's a side here. They just want us to kill each other, and then they'll come in and rebuild everything at taxpayers' expense. And there it is. The Free Syrian Army needs al-Qaeda now. There is the quote. Yeah, they are the main force. They are the main force. So here it is. U.S.-backed terrorists murder U.S. own ambassador in Libya. And, you know, I bring this up to mainline conservatives, and they just go, I'm like, do you understand that they're saying you're the terrorist? This whole homeland thing is set up for you. But they've got like a sycophantic fetish about giving up liberties and loving black uniforms and torture. And they're like, but it was for the Muslims. And I'm like, the globalists run the radical Muslims. Do you understand now? They just go, I just can't believe it. Yeah, I hear what you're saying, but what do you do? What do you do? And they just don't know how to respond. So continuing here, U.S.-backed terrorists murder U.S.-owned ambassador in Libya. And then they're going to put them in all these countries. And as I predicted a year and a half ago when the Libya thing started, then they'll say there has to be invasions to kick al-Qaeda out. But that's only simulant armies. They'll have, like, you know, just mortar some hills, say the U.S. troops are victorious, and then pull out. And then al-Qaeda is simply moved to the next place, as they've been done against Russia, against the Serbs, and then against the United States. That's the plan. Do you understand? The bankers run al-Qaeda. The New World Order runs al-Qaeda. But they don't want you worried about the New World Order. So they want you to give your rights up in the name of al-Qaeda, while the New World Order is the real enemy. So al-Qaeda murders U.S. ambassador and staff in Libya. Kurt Nemo, prisonplanet.com. Please get these articles out to everyone. U.S. ambassador to Libya killed in Benghazi attack. U.S. ambassador to Libya and three embassy staff were killed in an attack on the Benghazi consulate and a staff house refugee stormed by Islamists. That's al-Qaeda folks out of Saudi Arabia. Began blaming America for a film they said insulted the Prophet Muhammad. And see, al-Qaeda gets these jihadis who are real mind-controlled extremists, culturally mind-controlled. And so they're real. They really think they're fighting a jihad, and they're commanded by these double and triple agents that run al-Qaeda. And so when something like this gets out there, this YouTube video put out by the Reverend Jones and everything, you know that's a psyop, then it causes this clash of civilizations right on time for the Iran attack. And the globalists know the public's so dumbed down, they're now saying Iran's behind this. Even though they're Shiite, their archenemy is the Sunnis and the extremist sect of the Sunnis, the Wahhabist al-Qaeda's. But there, I got stacks here where they're like, see, we got to attack Iran. They killed our ambassador. NATO puts al-Qaeda in, has them do all this, war crimes everywhere. You know, on BBC, New York Times is proud. They were proud till people didn't like it. Of, look, they're going to kill this guy, or they've tortured him. They're going to make him be a suicide bomber, and other reports how they threatened to kill the whole family if the father won't blow himself up. And they're like, man, you got to admire al-Qaeda. People are like, hey, that's horrible. Oh, let us pull that video then. Oh, you didn't, you know, it's like, oh, torture's good. Let's torture people's kids in front of their parents. You know, they promoted that 6-7 years ago, and people didn't buy it. So we're like, oh, we'll send those to jail that we ordered to do it. Yeah, we don't torture, even though Bush didn't put a book out bragging he'd ordered torture. So U.S. ambassador to Libya killed. Gunman attacked and set fire to U.S. consulate in eastern city of Benghazi, the cradle of last year's uprising, you mean, of the Western-funded proxy war, against Muammar Gaddafi, who invested his money with the West and with Nicolas Sarkozy and financed his election and tried to make a deal, and they set him up. That's what they do. They don't want stabilization. They want rapine, death, murder, road warrior collapse. Late last night, another assault was mounted on the U.S. Embassy in Cairo. California-born Ambassador Christopher Stevens was killed. Yeah, and then his body drug around like Gaddafi's in the assault. And then again, we have John McCain with the ambassador looking like a Cheshire cat after they'd overthrown Libya and killed tens of thousands. And the killing just continues. I mean, they are just murdering the minority sects of Muslims. They are killing the Shiites with pleasure. They are blowing up the churches. I mean, it is fun. But again, the American people can't differentiate, so it's like, better get my rights up, al-Qaeda. And they're like, did you see al-Qaeda burning that American flag? Yeah, that our criminal government put in as they attacked the embassy in Cairo. But all they know is you're seeing an American flag burned. That's how dumb they think you are. The TSA today is like, gotta go in those pants. You saw what al-Qaeda did. Protesters attack U.S. diplomatic compounds in Egypt, Libya, and it's also going on in Afghanistan right now. Cairo protesters scale U.S. embassy wall, remove flag. Well, the American flag's been captured by the globalists now, so it's not even our flag. They wrap all their tyranny in it. But there you go, and They run al-Qaeda. I told you this clash of civilizations was coming. And when they're done, don't worry. The globalists are going to release a race-specific weapon that's going to kill the Arabic peoples first. The Central Asian Caucasoid group. I mean, that whole group there is a mix of Asian bloodlines and white bloodlines with some African bloodlines. That's why it's very hard, but they've studied it for a while. That's been in the news. To have a special weapon that just kills the Middle Easterners. But Dick Cheney talks about that, and it'll have some blowback, kind of like AIDS is designed for Africans, but it still can kill a Northern European, even though our cells don't have the main receptor sites. If you don't have T lymphocytes from methamphetamine use and things, then it can actually, if you're already in a immune system collapse from hundreds of sexual partners a week and drug use, then a Caucasian can get HIV. But it is a race weapon for Africans. That's why some countries, half the country has it. It's all a little loving, little global gift. But don't worry. Don't worry, though. You'll get a bioweapon, too, next. First, they're going to wipe those guys out. But they got to let them burn everything down first. So this is all part of a consolidation phase. Let's continue with what's really going on here. We told you all this was coming. The poor ambassador. We've got to fight al-Qaeda now. They think you're so dumb that you won't even understand they put al-Qaeda in. But Infowars.com and Prisonplanet.com are all reporting on it. Look at the photo. Was U.S. Ambassador lynched, is the Paul Joseph Watson question. And he looks like he actually wasn't shot, as they're saying. Looks like he's pretty conscious in these photographs coming out. And some nice men have him there. Oh, you put over 40,000 to the sword, Ambassador, helping with McCain. And look what happened to you. There you go. And the jihadis are going to have some fun with you. Man, talk about sick. But hey, that's what it takes. I mean, you know, you're a tough guy soldier, man. You're in there putting al-Qaeda in to rape and murder and kill everybody. And it blew back on you, didn't it, punk? Well, I'm not glad that guy's dead, but I tell you, he's a punk for putting al-Qaeda in there to chop up those little kids with machetes. But I know they're just North Africans. You know, they're not humans. This guy's a human, according to the globalists. You know, he's been killed. It's just terrible. And here's the Cairo-Tehran Express by the Washington Free Beacon. And the Egyptian-Iranian intelligence meeting prompts fears of new Middle East terror axis. And there's other articles conflating it and confusing it that, like, Iran's involved. And they got this fake feud going between U.S. and Israel so they can act like they're not going to attack Iran while the preparations are being made. If you believe any of that, well, then you're an idiot. This is the plan, and I've basically broken it down. Now, speaking of that, I thought I'd talk about some of the freedom here in the West, because it's really great and how it ties into the Chinese model that the globalists designed. Mom sues police over arrest, News 2 Houston, and they admit that she was in her front yard in a cul-de-sac in a rural area, and her children were on electric scooters. The funny thing is, when I lived inside the city, we lived in a community, and my children would be on scooters all day in the cul-de-sac with the other kids. Well, all the parents should be arrested. By the way, I wouldn't even watch them all the time. I'd let them play in the cul-de-sac with the other kids. There you go. I've admitted my endangerment of my children. I'm a horrible, evil criminal that in a cul-de-sac off the road, I let my children, my gosh, even ride bikes on the sidewalk. Whoa. You don't do that in a giant re-education camp here under the Zardoz Dome. As one individual put it that I heard talking the other day. Mom sues police over arrest. And here it is. Mom arrested and sent to jail for letting her kids play outside. The cops pulled up. She's even in the lawn chair watching them. And the cops said, endangerment. Slam her into the car, handcuffs. CPS comes, gets the kids. She's fighting back, though. She got the charges overthrown because they knew they couldn't get a jury conviction. They tried, though. And they got her, though. They put her in an orange jumpsuit, told her she was a piece of trash. I want to get her on the show. This is the new system. Oh, but wait, it gets better. It gets better. The freedom. Cameras in the school bathrooms going nationwide. Well, stay with us. All right, we are back as I desperately try to alert humanity to the incredible tyranny. During the break, we had Fox News on back there in the coffee room. And sure enough, they've dispatched drones over Libya now. I said it would take a year to 2 years, and I was dead on. to now they have to reinvade to fight al-Qaeda in Libya. Put al-Qaeda in to wreck everything, then go fight al-Qaeda. And here it is from CNN, Libyan official, U.S. drones seeking jihadist in Libya. Just out minutes ago, boom, another prediction comes true with precision. And how does it all come true with precision? Because it's a blueprint, a program. It's not West versus East. It's the bankers playing us off against each other. It's very, very sad to see this happening. We're like thrown in a cage like two pit bulls or two gamecocks, two roosters with razor blades on our feet. And we're supposed to just hack each other up. It's just amazing. I mean, I'm so angry. Next time I fly and some TSA wants to ask me questions, I'm just saying, look, man, I'm not playing your game, your chat down. Your boss is run al-Qaeda. Ooh, you make me angry. And see, they know everybody knows that now. So they're like, it doesn't matter. You're a right winger or whatever. I'm just tired of it. Man, call them on their bluff. How much more crazy does this have to get? How much more out of control? Every day I see mainstream news where they're arresting parents whose kids play in even their backyards. And when some nanny state tattletale calls the police on you, the cops have been told to act like God called. My reporters, we aired it here on the show yesterday, were out in Austin going, we want to know what you think about the TSA rolling on the streets. And a guy in a business suit starts taking pictures. He goes, I got somebody for you to talk to. And the cops came. I mean, that's Twilight Zone. You got people in business suits politely out on the street, out in front of Starbucks, and he calls the police on them. I mean, these people think that's normal. They're ready for roundups. They're ready. They love it. They love it. They're evil. It's the opposite of freedom. These are crazy people. The InfraGuard teams, just type in InfraGuard. It's the top stories on it after the FBI's own website, where they admittedly have people trained with firearms, hundreds of thousands of executives as their private secret militia with license to kill citizens. I mean, blow our heads off. And these people are on such power trips, they just can't wait to, I'm going to call photos, even call the cops. How dare you talk about TSA hitting the streets of America? I mean, that's how warped this country's gotten. It's how evil we are. We're in grave danger. I haven't scratched the surface of other news. We got big guests coming on. Dinesh D'Souza is set to be coming on the show. I've got one of the top films in the country right now on Obama and the collectivist garbage. And we've also got a lot of other guests today and a bunch of news here I'm going to be getting to. But I'm just desperate because I'm upset. And I just can't believe this nightmare is just happening. We've got to stop this. We've got to have an awakening and stop trusting the system and say, cut the government, cut it all, because the whole thing is taking over. They've got their Agenda 21 spies in every town, every city, every school now, taking over. They're shutting down all the power plants where I live. The power prices have doubled. They're totally taking over. There's inspectors everywhere now. They've got agents. It's like I'm living in the Soviet Union. Get prepared, get ready, and support our broadcast. Become PrisonPlanet.tv members to see the radio show and the nightly news. Go there, sign up today. $5.95 a month, 6 memberships for the price of 1. Your funds fund what we're doing. And the more you fund us, the more we can do. So if you're not a PrisonPlanet.tv member, become one today!
This is GCN, the Genesis Communications Radio Network.
For thousands of years, silver has been used as both a medicine and a preservative. But not all silver is equal. Silversol is an amazing new technology that has been clinically shown to be several hundred times more effective than colloid or ionic silvers. It can destroy thousands of times more pathogens than older silver technology. Silversol resonates at the same frequency as germicidal light used in labs to kill bacteria and viruses, enabling it to kill without direct contact. Silversol is a broad-spectrum microbial that creates no resistance and does not harm beneficial bacteria, making it ideal for daily use. It can be used internally as well as topically and is highly effective against viruses, bacteria, molds, and yeasts. With threats like West Nile virus, colds, flus, or any other emergency situation, arm yourself with supernatural silver. Silversol liquid and gel are perfect for on-the-go emergency preparedness and can provide protection at home, school, or work. Go to supernaturalsilver.com and be prepared for any emergency. Remember the promo code Alex Says for 20% off. That's www.supernaturalsilver.com and like us on Facebook.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCM Radio Network.
Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
All right, coming up, we've got Dinesh D'Souza, author of the book that has been turned into the big blockbuster hit, Obama 2016, Obama's America. We have, of course, the U.S. ambassador to Libya killed, deader than a hammer, drug around. And here is the latest out of CNN just out a few minutes ago. U.S. using drones to look for targets tied to attack, U.S. official says, looking for jihadists. So they put them in, and then now want to go claim they're going to kill them. They'll probably just kill somebody else they want to get rid of and blame it on them. But pretty amazing to see all of this going on. And a Marine unit has been dispatched to secure consulate in Benghazi after attack. So it is definitely heating up right now. We'll be getting to more of that coming up throughout the broadcast today. We will also continue breaking down other news. This is something we've been covering a lot now. Even children in your backyard, the police are coming and taking you to jail. Or a mother with her children in a cul-de-sac on scooters. That you're just not allowed to do that. The neighbor called. When the snitch calls, the police come and arrest you. If you're an old man cleaning a gun in your backyard in the country, your neighbor sees it from 200 yards away, you're going to jail. The cops don't care. They're like, well, we better pick you up for psychological reasons. Because if a snitch calls, we've got to empower that snitch that they're God. So if he even needs a Supreme Court now, you could just have a snitch, busybody neighbor, just announce the sun won't come up in the morning. And, you know, they've got to, like, send a neutron beam at the sun to blow it up or something because they can't let it come up in the morning if a snitch says it isn't coming up. You know, we've got to stop it. I mean, my point is they act like these snitches are God. It's satire, folks. But what's not satire is mom sues police over arrest, LaPorte, Texas. Stay-at-home mom from LaPorte has filed a lawsuit against the city's police department and an unknown officer and one of her neighbors. Good. Tammy Cooper said she was wrongfully accused of endangering. Yeah, they should charge the neighbor with a false report. Well, the cops, I mean, where's the common sense here? Tammy Cooper said she was wrongly accused of endangering her children and was even forced to spend the night in jail, all because she let her kids play outside in a cul-de-sac in a rural area as she sat in a lawn chair. And they dropped the charges, but it just shows the insanity. Now, this is a short little segment, so I won't go to him now. We're going to go to break, and we've got him, Dinesh D'Souza, very excited about this interview because, as you know, a few weeks ago I went and saw the new film by writer and director, 2016, Obama's America. And he, of course, works in the Reagan White House. We'll give you his bio when we come back here in just a moment. But it gets into the psychology of why they want to lower the standard of living in the Western world, which is an admitted policy. I mean, they pushed the Copenhagen tax 3 years ago in Denmark when they were over there. They pushed that whole UN program saying they wanted to lower our standard, not build up the third world. They want to block its development as well. And it all ties into this whole Agenda 21, the whole nine yards. So we're going to go to break here in a moment and come back with Dinesh D'Souza. And again, he's in the news today. Deadline Hollywood is reporting that the 2016 Obama's America filmmaker reacts to president slam looking for network to air before election, says mainstream media refusing coverage. Well, I mean, if Dinesh D'Souza just wanted to make money, that's probably a good thing, is that the theaters are still packed with people trying to see it. So the fact that they tried to suppress this, some of my friends were trying to get this to town like a month ago when it was first coming out because none of the theaters would show it. They were having to pay to bring it to a theater, but then that got canceled because then it became a hit in limited theaters, so it got there anyway. So that was pretty interesting as well, just to see how the system does not want you seeing this, does not want you seeing that information. We'll be right back with Dinesh D'Souza after this quick break. Last month, his film has been in the top three. It is the second highest grossing political documentary of all time, or documentary period, right behind Fahrenheit 9/11. It's already made more than two of Michael Moore's other films combined, $26 million. And it hasn't even hit DVD or Netflix yet. And I'm not going to waste time going over his lengthy bio. Most of you know him. Dinesh D'Souza is the maker and a writer and director, and it's based on his book, 2016 Obama's America, that the system fought to even get in the theaters. I went and saw it, was very impressed with the quality of the production. I disagree with a few things in it, and we'll get into that with Dinesh D'Souza, who joins us until the bottom of the hour. Of course, he worked in the Reagan White House as a world affairs advisor and a policy analyst, and he is a best-selling author and journalist, and he joins us now. Thank you for coming on the show, Dinesh.
It's a great pleasure to be on.
Okay, so, wow, tell us about the huge success of the film and where you're going.
Well, the film has become absolutely huge. It started in the summer as a small film showing initially in a single theater in Houston, Texas. Then it went to four theaters, expanded out to about 100. But it did so well in those 100 theaters that it jumped to 1,000 theaters. It's now in 2,000 theaters. So it's pretty much any American who wants to see the film can find it. And on our website, which is just 2016themovie.com, we'll allow you to see a trailer and see where it's playing. The film has now become, it just surpassed two of Michael Moore's films, Sicko and Bowling for Columbine, and also Al Gore's film called An Inconvenient Truth. So we are now, remarkably, the second most successful political documentary of all time.
Simply amazing. It shows people are desperate for something than the mainstream pap they're being fed, certainly trailblazing in a big way here. Dinesh, the basic thesis, for those that don't know, is that what? Obama is a global wealth redistributor?
Yes. Many people think that Obama is a wealth redistributor in America, and he is. So when they talk about the 1%, the 99%, they think that Obama means in the United States. But Obama's a global guy. I mean, remember, here's a guy who grew up in part in Indonesia, made multiple trips to Pakistan, to Kenya. And so Obama looks at all this from the world point of view. And I think when he thinks of the 1%, the 99%, he puts all of America in the 1%. And there are 99 hungry nations encircling America, all of whom want America's standard of living, America's wealth, America's power, and so on. So Obama is not just recycling money in the United States. He's also transferring large amounts of wealth from America to the rest of the world.
Dinesh, I want to get into the fact that you're in the news today talking about trying to get your film on television. Break that down. I see Deadline Hollywood reports exclusive 2016 Obama's America filmmaker reacts to President Slam, and he's looking for a network to air before election, says mainstream media refusing coverage. Elaborate on that, Dinesh.
Well, it's been kind of odd that, remember when Michael Moore made his films, this guy was everywhere. He was covered by the networks. He was on all the Sunday shows. He was covered widely in the newspapers and so on. Our film, for a long time, was being ignored by the White House, and lots of mainstream outlets just weren't covering it. They were just pretending like it didn't exist. We're in a political season. This is the most successful political documentary of the year by far, and yet it was getting no coverage at all. So this was peculiar, and I think part of it was there was a sense that this documentary has harmful new information that might cause people to change their mind about Obama. So let's not cover it and let's pretend it doesn't exist. Now the White House has figured out, they're like, this has gotten too big, we can't ignore it, it's everywhere. So they've come out blasting it. But, you know, what a clumsy, inept blast it is. Because they're alleging all these errors in the film that are actually, not only are they not errors, but they're easily provable. And so I'm very happy to get into this one-on-one debate with Barack Obama. I know it's a debate that I'm not worried that I'm going to lose.
Now, continuing here with the success of the film, do you think it is having a major bearing on the election, or could it be something that actually causes people to wake up to what Obama's doing and swing the election over to Romney?
Well, the film isn't political in that way. I mean, it's not a film that's sort of a just don't vote for Obama. In fact, the bigger issue here is the American dream. And in the film, we contrast two dreams, the American dream and Obama's dream. I'm an immigrant. I grew up in India. And so my dream is the American dream. I believe in a society of merit, a society of in which free markets generate wealth. America is a force for good and for freedom in the world. That's my American dream. Well, Obama has a different dream, and it's the dream from his father. That's the title of his autobiography. And so in the film, we go and find out who was his father. What was his father's dream? And it turns out to be a third world dream, in some ways an anti-American dream. Certainly it's a dream of reducing America's influence in the world, treating America, if you will, as a rogue nation. So in some ways, it is true that Obama holds these ideas, but they're wider than Obama. They're in fact believed by many people in Riyadh and Jakarta and Rio de Janeiro. It's just that we've never had a president of the United States who holds these views.
Now, we have the maker, the author, the director, you name it, of the new hit documentary, Dinesh D'Souza, 2016, Obama's America, on with us. Here's my issue. I've studied history, as you have, and you could undoubtedly say until the 50s and 60s, the United States, who certainly wasn't perfect, did have a policy to actually try to build up the third world and really empower them and bring them freedom. Since then, perfect example, putting radical jihadists in Libya, putting them in Syria. They've now killed the U.S. ambassador in Libya. And NATO's funding this. This is bigger than just Obama. In your film, you show the Middle East spreading out into areas of Central Asia, up into Russia, Western Europe, a new jihad, similar to what we saw triggering the Crusades. We see this, Islam spreading like Mordor or something in Lord of the Rings, a similar map. But then we're told that's what Obama wants. Well, wait a minute. I mean, the big mega banks funding Obama, the same ones that are funding Mitt Romney, Dinesh, they are the ones going with this policy. So my issue is this is a lot bigger than Obama.
Well, it is bigger than Obama, I agree. And in some ways, we've got to be fair. Obama didn't cause the Arab Spring. There was a revolt within the Arab world. My criticism of Obama is the way that he's reacting or responding to it. I mean, look, there's a power struggle going on in Egypt right now. It's between the military and between the Muslim Brotherhood. The Muslim Brotherhood is the largest organization of radical Islam in the world. So whose side is Obama on? He's on the side of the Muslim Brotherhood. The Obama administration has been warning the Egyptian military, you guys better turn over power or we're going to cut off U.S. aid. Now, wow, here's the United States. We had in Egypt an ally, Mubarak, a dictator to be sure, but a dictator friendly to Israel, friendly to the United States. We helped to push him out, and now we're accelerating a transition of power so that our own deadly enemies, the radical Muslims, get a hold of a major country. Look, the radical Muslims already control Iran. If they now control Egypt, there's only one other big country left for them to take over, and that's Saudi Arabia. So that's where the film goes. It says, wait a minute, if Saudi Arabia falls, then all the major legs of the tripod are now in place, and all the smaller countries, Jordan, Bahrain, the United Arab Emirates, and so on, they're never going to be able to hold out against a tide of radical Islam sweeping the region. So what's going on with Obama? I mean, some people think Obama's a bungler. He doesn't know what he's doing and so on. I say no. I think Obama knows what's happening. It's very predictable. It's happening right in front of our eyes. But Obama is trying to reduce U.S. influence in the region. And part of that is to weaken our allies and allow some of the bad guys to come to power.
Well, Dinesh, let me ask you this question. I mean, clearly, a lot of Obama's family has CIA ties and connections. When we hear that, you know, he's a radical Muslim who wants to overthrow us, I mean, I think that is just propaganda. I know you're not saying that. You're saying he's kind of a world citizen, a globalist. He wants to diminish American power. I agree. But not to give it to the Muslims. They're just going to use those guys, the radical Muslims, to destabilize. This is more of a British great game, speaking of colonialism. And I see the mega corporations that brag that they've conquered Europe through derivatives fraud and conquered us. I mean, I can play the clips of CNBC saying that the world's been conquered by private banks who aren't free market. And I see them always waging war against sovereignty and actually the old colonialism. So I see Obama not even as anti-colonialist. He is siding with globalism that is a modern corporate colonialism that actually teams up with the third world, not to empower them, but to leverage out the first world. Look at the example of the globalist teaming up with China. Now, I mean, I know that's a complex issue, but I know you know what I'm talking about.
Well, I do think that there is an alliance between a guy like Obama. Now, take a guy like George Soros, who has his own global agenda. Soros and Obama, in my opinion, are not coming from the same place. Soros has a European disdain for America. He uses financial leverage. I think he would love to try to pull America down. Obama has a third world ideology. This is the anti-colonial part. So Obama and Soros are coming from different places, but in a way they have a common project. And the common project is to level down the power of the United States.
Well, that's actually true, then. I mean, what you're saying is true.
Off its pedestal.
Well, sure. I mean, Soros openly says he's wanted to kill the dollar forever. He's wanted to get rid of our liberties forever. He is an admitted, you know, as a young man, a Nazi helper and sympathizer. How is this monster allowed to operate inside of our country and run groups like Media Matters, whose memos have come out, wanting to destroy alternative media? These are authoritarians. So how did the power structure, who's not far from perfect, but how did they let somebody like Obama get in who does want to destroy our sovereignty, who would pay $22 billion to ship General Motors, Volt and Cadillac factories, Dinesh, to China? I mean, he really does want to destroy this country.
I think he wants to downsize it. I mean, I would stay away from the word destroy myself, but I'm just trying to be as cautious as I can in making the case so that it really sticks and is anchored on the facts. I mean, there's no question Obama will give defense contracts to Brazilians over American companies, which is a very odd thing to do when it comes to defense. Every country wants to have its defense contracts stay within the country, but not apparently Obama. Obama will basically say that American companies that advertise by American are being, quote, discriminatory. And so in trade deals that he makes in the Far East, he says, well, we're going to try to exclude those kinds of companies that are being, quote, discriminatory. Mm-hmm. Discriminatory how? By advertising by American. So, look, this is a very unusual guy that we have in the Oval Office. He's not Bill Clinton. I think we've already figured that out. But he's not even Jimmy Carter. Jimmy Carter made a lot of mistakes, but he made mistakes because he was a buffoon. He was incompetent. Obama's mistakes aren't like that. It isn't that Obama's getting results opposite to what he intends. He intends the results he's getting.
Dinesh D'Souza, maker of the second biggest political documentary in all time, 26 million grossed in a month. It's going to be in the theaters another month and a half, then go to DVD. Look, I think your film is a masterpiece. I mean, it's cinematically, the style. I'm a filmmaker myself. The Obama Deception is free online for folks that want to watch that. I mean, I was impressed with what you brought to the table because most political documentaries are at about a fourth grade level. And I'm not insulting your film, but yours is at, you know, at a eighth grade, 10th grade level. And I guess in media, they say keep it at about a fourth grade level. But I mean, you actually tackle issues of globalism that, there's one point in the film, correct me if I'm wrong, where you say and show the evidence that it's not that they want to build up the third world. They want to bring us down to that level. And that's a big deal.
Yeah, with Obama, it's not about building up. I mean, he rarely even talks that much about the inner city or about the poor. He gets excited when he's pulling down the rich. That's his target. And that's when you begin to see Obama's, his voice rises and he gets animated and so on. So ultimately, this is about leveling down. I agree. And it also, but not just wealth, he's also leveling American power. I think he doesn't like a world in which one country, America, is the sole superpower. He'd like to see see Russia come up, China come up, India come up, Brazil come up. He wants to see a multipolar world in which there are many countries sharing power. And by the way, many countries that have a roughly equal number of nuclear weapons. That's why he's spending less time trying to prevent Iran from getting a nuclear bomb and more time trying to slash the American nuclear arsenal.
Let me say this to you. I mean, obviously, you've worked inside the Republican White House of Ronald Reagan. I think it's fair to say you're a Republican operative.
No, that's not fair to say. I mean, I worked in the Reagan White House in my mid-20s. I mean, I'm 51 years old and the president of a college, so I just want to say I'm a conservative, but I mean, I have nothing to do with Romney or the RNC. I'm not.
Okay, well, then now that you've said that, I respect that. And again, I haven't gone over your LinkedIn bio because of the time, but you're obviously a scholar as well. Here's the bottom line. Romney is the worst Republican I have ever seen. Obviously, I don't have to list everything. When he was actually a governor, abortion, open borders, restrictions of guns, carbon taxes, wrote the Obama plan. I mean, all of this. My issue is that I want Obama out of there. I don't want him to not be facing re-election. I mean, even if Romney's going to be bad, at least he'll be facing re-election. So I am saying, okay, I see people that want to support Romney. My issue is this. What will you do if Romney gets in and continues what some of these monopoly capitalists want that have been financing Obama, who want tyranny, not liberty, who don't want a free market? What are you going to do to Mitt Romney if he gets in and continues what Obama's been doing?
Hey, listen, don't give me any ideas. I may have to make another film. But look, I don't know about Romney. As you know, we don't mention Romney in the film. This really is a referendum. I think this election is a referendum on Obama. If I had to say what this election is about, I'd even say it's about Obama versus Obama, right? There's the celluloid Obama, the mythical Obama that was put out in 2008, the unifier, the healer, the centrist. I claim that Obama does not exist. And then there's the real Obama, the guy in the White House, the guy who can't change, the guy who can't move to the center, the guy who has been formed in his mind by a combination of radicals, revolutionaries, in one case a former communist and domestic terrorist, Bill Ayers. I mean, these were his buddies. These are the guys. This is the real Obama. So it's a matter of, does America want to...
Wow. So you're saying all the communist pornographers and weirdos that he lived with and was associated with, you're saying that wasn't just his foundation cover as a leftist. You're saying he really is a real globalist, Marxist-Leninist, deindustrializing crazy man.
Well, here's what I'm saying. Frank Marshall Davis was introduced to him by his grandfather. So, all right, I'll say that was somebody that his grandfather brought him in front of, and he was only 10 years old when he met Frank Marshall Davis. But every other guy, the Palestinian radical Edward Said, the Brazilian socialist Unger at Harvard Law School, Bill Ayers, the incendiary preacher Jeremiah Wright. I mean, Obama didn't bump into these guys. He sought them out. Because he wanted to hang around radical, revolutionary guys who he imagined to be surrogate fathers, kind of like his real dad who wasn't around.
Let me raise this in the 5 minutes we've got left with Dinesh D'Souza here, the maker of 2016 Obama's America, which is an amazing film. Dinesh, looking at this then, if he's as bad as you say, and I think the evidence is there, fast and furious, a false flag against the Second Amendment, the list goes on and on. We've got all these Obama advisors in the Financial Times of London, you name it, saying, don't worry if he's down in the polls. There'll be an event we're going to blame on their enemies. They don't say they're going to stage it, but they imply, don't worry, something's coming. I'm sure you've seen that in the news because it's been pushed for 2 years. Are you concerned he could pull an October surprise?
Not so much. He could, and that's a possibility. What I really do in the film and my work is I say, I don't even need to go there. I don't even need to speculate about what he could do. I'm just going to look at what he has done, and I'm going to extrapolate out to what happens if he just keeps doing that over the next 4 years. So he's added $5 trillion in debt. Let's say he adds another $5 trillion, a very cautious and reasonable estimate. Then America will be $20 trillion in debt, and $10 trillion of that will have been added by one man, Obama. And then I said, wait a minute, why would one guy want to do that? Why would someone want to saddle his country with almost unrepayable debt? And then I offer a theory. I said, well, maybe he sees debt as a way to settle America's colonial debt. It's kind of like we owe the rest of the world. I can't get a foreign aid program passed that would transfer trillions of dollars in wealth, but I can achieve the same effect because if our children and grandchildren have to pay back all this debt and some of that debt is owed to Kuwaitis and to Saudis and to Chinese, well, that's another way to transfer larger trillions of dollars outside the United States to all these other countries.
But, again, I go back to the issue. Goldman Sachs, J.P. Morgan, I mean, you look at the list of people that are not just supporting Obama, they supported all of his policies. They are financing everything he wants. I'm saying these globalists, we need conservatives and libertarians to recognize that there are two different groups of capitalists. They're the free market capitalist. They're the monopoly capitalist who want tyranny, who don't want freedom, who don't want us to have choice, who are working through big government types like Obama to convert us to an authoritarian system. That's all I'm saying is that all this corruption and globalism didn't just start with Obama.
Yes, I agree with that. And then even as I mentioned debt, well, you know, you're well aware, I'm well aware that Reagan added $200 billion a year in debt. Bush, of course, was a big spender. Bush's largest deficit was $500 billion. But again, keep things in perspective. Obama's smallest deficit is more than double that. It's $1 trillion. And so I think what Obama's done is just lift things to a sort of complete and unacceptable new level.
I hear you. It just makes me so upset to see this country and the TSA sticking their hands down our pants looking for bin Laden while NATO and our own government is putting al-Qaeda in as the main shock force in Libya and Syria. It's so scary to see what both parties have become, the torture, the secret arrest, the wars, all of it. And I cover all that in the Obama deception. I made it 3.5 years ago. It's all come true, unfortunately. Dinesh, have you seen the Obama deception?
I have not. I would actually like to very much.
All right. Well, we're going to go to break here, and I'll talk to you as we go to break and as you leave us, and then I'll find a P.O. box or something to send the film to you. Because, I mean, I get it. Obama's really bad, but I think he's a manifestation of how far along this globalist line we've gotten. Do you think Obama, in closing, may backfire on the establishment and may cause a pendulum swing back towards liberty?
I certainly hope so. I mean, I hope that people are using this sort of intense interest in politics that will be generated this year to think about what's happened to the American dream. And, you know, is this American era, which began in 1945?
We never even got into You Didn't Build That.
We're on the march. The empire's on the...
I say, I'm impressed with Dinesh D'Souza because normally a Republican type, but he is the head of a major university as well, you know, would just sit there and go to talking points and wouldn't admit what I was saying was accurate. But, you know, he basically responded. You heard him. He basically responded and said, look, I'm just focusing on what I can prove and a basic message so Obama doesn't get reelected. And it's the honesty that I appreciated from him as an author and as a filmmaker. So, again, and I wasn't trying to insult him. I said, most films are at a fourth grade level. Yours is at an eighth grade level. And I wasn't trying to be arrogant. He pretty much admitted that. He goes, yeah, I'm just trying to get some basic facts across. Because they say in politics, dumb it down. And that's why we've gotten to this place, because it's a feedback loop where people don't understand basic facts to the point of they can have al-Qaeda openly being put in by Western governments while we're told give our rights up because al-Qaeda is going to get us. It doesn't fly. I want my freedom back. I don't want feds on the streets running checkpoints who aren't even sworn officers. Be bad enough if it was real police. I mean, our republic is in trouble. And by the way, I'm not envious of people when they have a big hit film. I say more power to them. Great trailblazing. That's something I've always intended to try to do, and we will do it in the future. That's why I haven't had made a film in over a year myself, just because I've been busy getting the TV ready. I've always intended to develop the subscription-based system for 5 years and then put it on television. Beck's now doing that. I understand the internet revolution because I grew up through it, and that's why we've been on the cutting edge. And so I'm glad for their film, and I'm glad it's doing well. I want the Obama deception that's free online and been seen more than 40 million times to be seen. It's free on Google and YouTube and all over. I want you to get the DVD with the expanded extras at InfoWarsStore.com. so you can have a record of it, because they can erase it off YouTube or Google. I want you to give copies to people, because this film exposes that they would then get rid of Obama and bring in a new globalist puppet, but that they would have him in there to blame it on leftists, to, you know, to act like, oh, it was just Obama that was doing it, not the power structure itself. And that's what the Obama deception basically explains. And that's why it's so important. So InfoWarsStore.com, get the Obama deception, ProPure water filters, 10% off there, best gravity fed filter anywhere, the Life Straw for out in the field, all of the great products and things that I have that I use to be self-sufficient. It's all there at InfoWarsStore.com or InfoWarsShop.com. We'll get you there. You can also link through. You can also link through any time at InfoWars.com over there to the different websites. Now, we do have some good news, at least at one level, and it's up at InfoWars.com right now. Congress smacks down the TSA, orders agency to reduce pat-downs. They've done this before, though. They're not going to stop. They grope every good-looking woman and every child because that's what they're into. Orders agencies to reduce pat-downs, use private security screeners, and address scanner health. See, that's the problem. The TSA, this Republican plan's not good, now goes out and they certify not just private security people, but they go out and they certify the police now. So this untrained, out of control, out of their jurisdiction, not even sworn officers, they wave a magic Homeland Security executive order wand. Well, you saw cases of groping at high school proms in places like New Mexico, Santa Fe last year. And the federal judge said, okay, just have TSA there to train you, and then it's okay. Then you can stick your hands down Jenny's pants or Billy's pants. I mean, this is so crazy. So we're running out of the jaws of the TSA into private screeners. They'll do the same thing. They're also saying, oh, trusted travelers will wear a bracelet now. That is only one step away from what Homeland Security looked at 4 years ago, all of us wearing taser bracelets. Yes, you heard me right. And you're like, that'll never happen. Oh, really? They're arresting mothers nationwide for children playing in their front yards or backyards or in the cul-de-sac. They're arresting parents that let their 12-year-olds ride the bike to 7-Eleven. They're arresting, I mean, they're putting cameras in bathrooms everywhere at public schools. I have that in the news today, in the U.S. and in England. Mothers who breastfeed, they're calling the police on. When a woman at the mall sits down and covers herself up, big deal. They're making our normal bodies and being human bad. The nanny state is a giant re-education camp takeover system. But an important article by Steve Watson at InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.com, Congress smacks down TSA. A new House report has slammed the Transportation Security Administration, failing to meet taxpayers' expectations, and also lying about the efficacy of the body scanners. They've been caught lying about the radiation dangers, lying and saying it's safe, and saying they have reports by John Hopkins, and it turns out John Hopkins' report says it gives you cancer. I mean, they're just incredible liars. Oh, we don't strip search old ladies. Turns out they do. Oh, we don't go down your pants. Then the video of them doing it. They just lie. We're going to stop searching 12 and under. They accelerate it. So it's like an occupational army. They're there to break your will, to bring in this tyranny. And I'm starting to see mainstream media starting to get it and admitting that. Also coming up after our next guest leave us, scientists control rats' dreams with technique that could enhance memory. It's flashing lights, folks. Same thing they're putting in these new light bulbs. I'm going to break that down. New DARPA robot can automatically track and kill people. Combat robots. That's at InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. Michelle Obama launches a new supermarket shopping guide, but no mention of GMO, aspartame, MSG, gluten, anything like that. Just, oh, you're getting unhealthy, so the government needs to take over. And meanwhile, I was talking to a man, a longshoreman the other night, and he also told me how he'd just been in South Korea, and I went and looked this up. You can't even get an aspirin or vitamins at the store. You have to go to a pharmacy and pay pharmacy rates for vitamin E. Hundreds of dollars if you convert it to U.S. money instead of $10 for some vitamin E. This is what Europe's passing with Codex Alimentarius, and joining us to break that down by backed by popular demand is Dr. Joel Wallach. He's published numerous books on dietary deficiencies, conducts approximately 300 lectures annually. He had $25 million of government funding as a top zoologist He's got multiple medical degrees, but his first one is as a veterinary medicine. And he discovered that a lot of different diseases were mineral-based or vitamin-based. Well, just like scurvy's vitamin C missing. A lot of adults have scurvy now, and the doctors won't even tell you. So we're going to be breaking that down with him and that attack. And we've got somebody who I'm a big fan of. Theo Ratliff is an American former professional basketball player who last played with the NBA's Los Angeles Lakers. Primarily a center, he was an excellent shot blocker who has led the league three times in blocks per game. Wow, a league leader. As of 2011, he is ranked 18th all-time in career blocks and 13th all-time in career blocks per game. Ratliff played basketball at Dolphins High School and later graduated the University of Wyoming. He is also the owner of Rome Gladiators, and he is on with us. He is the maker, well, I mean, he's endorsing a proprietary blend for him of Rebound that I take. And for people watching on PrisonPlanet.tv, here you can, I'm actually on some Rebound right now, an amazing energy, stamina, sports drink that is just off the charts. And so there it is right over there on the document cam shot. We can show people the Rebound FX. They've got it in different flavors right there. They've got Berry Boost and Citrus Punch. I personally like the Berry Boost the most, just like I like Polymers Plus that's berry. I just like berry better than citrus, but to each their own. And it's all available, I should add, as well at InfoWarsHealth.com. So we're also engaged in good old-fashioned capitalism here because I searched out the best vitamin and minerals for myself. Aaron lost 92 pounds on it, as you know, and I found longevity. And the testimonials just pour in, so they're both here to talk about that. We're going to Theo here in a moment, but let's bring up Dr. Wallach, Joel Wallach. Tell us about Theo Ratliff, and then we'll get his testimony here and talk about the amazing product Rebound that he, you know, basically envisioned out of the other longevity products because of the response he got.
Well, thank you, Alex. It's always good to be with you, first of all. And then Theo is a great American. He's a great role model for young people who want to be healthy and yet play sports. And Theo's career was over, I don't know, 10, 12 years ago, whatever it is. He had only 28 years old. He was playing for the Atlanta Hawks, had bone-to-bone arthritis in both knees. Cartilage popped off his right hip, had to have it surgically stapled back down. Caught a pass during a game and actually fractured his wrist. And the orthopedic surgeons at the Atlanta Hawks refused to sign off on him and said, hey, this guy's too fragile to play professional ball. And a mutual friend introduced us, a guy by the name of Mike Glenn, who's an ESPN moderator, played for the Atlanta Hawks for 10 years himself, used to be called the Stinger, introduced Theo to the Youngevity program. We got Theo going on the essentially what is today the Healthy Start Pack for his body weight. He's a big fella, and he's on the Healthy Start Pack plus our glucogel to rebuild his cartilage. And within 90 days, we had him rebuilt. He was able to go back and get his position back. And he's been playing ever since, essentially free of any breakdown because he's been taking not only the 90 essential nutrients regularly just to maintain himself, but also the Rebound, which we designed for him. It has 100 nutrients in it to replace everything you're sweating out. Gatorade only has two. Water has none. And when you sweat, Alex, you're not sweating out water. You're sweating out a soup of all the nutrients you have floating around your blood. You have a perfect diet. You're getting 90 essential nutrients, so you're sweating out 90 nutrients. Most people don't. They have anywhere from 60 to 70 nutrients floating around their blood, and they sweat them out. And then you drink Gatorade. You're only getting two replace it. And that's why people break down in their joints. They break down in their muscles. They have heart attacks. They get diabetes, and they die 25 years early.
Amazing. Let's bring him up on the air, Theo Ratliff, to break this down. Theo, thanks for joining us today.
Oh, great to be here, man. And thank you for having me on. I don't know if you're Mr. Jones or Alex or what you prefer to be
called. Oh, sir, please call me. Please call me Alex. I'll call you Theo.
Yes, it's a great opportunity to be on your show. And always my man, Dr. Wallach, always putting out that knowledge and letting people know what the real deal is as far as with these minerals and their health.
Describe what happened to you. I mean, he just encapsulated it, but take your time. I mean, because I was reading in sports medicine until recently, they never even really discussed that you need a full spectrum of vitamins and minerals. And then, of course, you guys sweat more than anybody in probably any other sport. I mean, because it's so aerobic. Break down your story.
Well, I mean, I've been a guy that always took care of his body, you know, when I was younger, got proper rest, ate proper foods, did all the right things. And probably it was my second year in the league, going into my third year. I banged knees with somebody, ended up having to go through a microfracture surgery. I had to play the year throughout with a microfracture surgery. And, you know, when you get the microfracture, you know, you get a lot of swelling, a constant swelling, even after you're done, even after you have the surgery. So I was going through constant swelling, was able to play through it. Lo and behold, ended up going to Philadelphia, playing with Philadelphia, starting, really making a name for myself, leading the leagues in blocks, and just playing well. You know, body was still kind of breaking down at the same time, but I was able to fight through it. But lo and behold, about my fifth year in the league in 2001, I ended up being, you know, one of the top defensive guys in the league at the time. I think we had the best record in the league at the time before the All-Star break, and probably 2-3 games before the All-Star game, I went up to block the shot on, I think it was Dirk Nowitzki in Dallas, and I came down on my wrist trying to just catch myself. A routine ended up fracturing my wrist. So wasn't able to play, you know, one of the top centers in the league at the time. So during that time, we have what we call a trade deadline. So because I wasn't able to play and wasn't able to perform at that time, I ended up getting traded for Dikembe Mutombo from Atlanta to Philly, and I ended up going to Atlanta. So then play the rest of the year, just rehab, heal my hand back. And then during the summertime, after I was healthy and everything, I just went up. This couldn't have been no more than 2 or 3 days when I started playing again. I just went up and jumped for a routine ball, and I ended up tearing the labrum in my hip. So I had to sit out again. So I went through a surgery, tried to get the body back together, but it just wasn't working out. I thought after 6 years, it looked like I was heading for retirement. So lo and behold, I heard Mike Glenn, who's our commentator, which Dr. Wallach said, was speaking to another gentleman on the team about minerals and mineral deficiencies and calcium and different things of that nature, and talking about the different diseases. And I was like, man, is that what's been going on with me? So I pulled him over to the side and I told him, look, man, you got to break these minerals down to me. Break this thing down, because I know I've done everything possible to try to stay in this league and build my body up and do all the right things. But my body's just breaking down on me. It's like my bones are getting brittle. So he sat me down along with a guy named Phil Oliver, and they explained to me about the calcium deficiency, the different disease you can get from calcium. But one of the biggest things that they told me about was athletes don't live long. I mean, when athletes finish playing, they have an average lifespan of probably 55.
Look at Will Chamberlain. Look at all these guys.
Right. And you see it just from how guys pass away, you know, constantly and throughout the retired ranks. So they kind of explained to me about you're losing your minerals. You know, you've been doing it all your life. You don't know it. All you do is taste the salt and the minerals, because that's what you're familiar with. But at the same time, you're losing 90 different minerals that are coming out your body as you sweat. And I was amazed, you know, when they was telling me this. I'm like, man, could this be what the situation is? And then Dr. Wallach explained to me about growing cartilage back, and I'm telling him about my knees swelling up every time I run, and the hip and all this stuff. And, you know, it was to the point where, you know, I was always a great listener, but when they start saying the things that they were saying, me being from Alabama and thinking about a lot of the old remedies that grandma used to use, it made sense to me.
Well, yeah, so, grandma used to grind up bone to put it in the bread, and grandma used to, you know, tell people they needed to eat clay and things. And I mean, you see the deer out doing it. I mean, I was watching a show last night, showed elephants sticking their trunks way down into the mud to get minerals. I mean, animals know this. Why have we forgotten this?
Right. So when he told me about the gelatin and being able to recreate cartilage and build your body back with the minerals and different things of that nature, I got on it diligently. I did not stop taking it. I still, to this day, I wake up and I take my minerals every single day, you know, like clockwork. You know, once they explain to me, it's like food. It's not a matter of what you consume as far as the amount, but it's because it's like food. It's natural and it's a plant-derived mineral, so it absorbs in your body, you know, 100%. And when you hear something like that, you kind of throw up a red flag. But as you do your research and you learn about plants and how they work and how they function in your body, you tend to understand. So I got on the program diligently and was just all out with the program and was able to build my body back and went on to lead the league in blocks that year, was up for defensive player of the year at the same time for the next 2 years. And, you know, went on to Portland, transferred to Portland and was able to sign a big contract. And during that time, because I was so diligent on the program, they created this rebound FX to keep me sustained throughout the game as far as with the energy, you know, that I need when guys are dying in that fourth quarter and they see my motor is still up at 100%, it gave me an advantage. So, you know, this product has been great for me.
So especially formulated off what they thought you would need for long distance stamina. Now break down, because I've seen you on the news talk about this. What started happening is everything was starting to degenerate, breaking under this whole life of stress and intense sports as you were depleting your minerals and vitamins and things were starting to break down. I mean, how fast did you see a response when you started taking basically the Healthy Start Pack and the glycogel and other things? I mean, what was the response you saw, Theo?
For one, it's like a shock to the system because you're getting something that your body been craving your whole life. So once you start taking it, you get energized, you get rejuvenated. It's like a whole light bulb goes off.
Well, that's my problem is I've gotten more aggressive, actually. I've got to be honest. You know, the side effect of taking all these vitamins and minerals is I feel aggressive like when I was 20.
right. You feel young, energetic. Muscles get strong, everything. So it's, you know, that said, you know, when I first started taking it, you know, within a month, I felt my body being different. You know, it takes a lot longer because I had the injuries already, pre-existing stuff. So as I continued to take and was able to do a little bit more and started not to seeing that swelling in the knees and in the joints and not having the ice down and doing all this different stuff, then it was like, okay, I'm getting back to myself. I'm getting back to that 20-year-old, you know, Theo Riley, where I can jump and do all the things that I need to do out on the floor comfortably, you know.
So nothing less than miraculous. And so, I mean, you do, I mean, in your own words, you basically owe it to longevity, you've said, and discovering this, you got how many more years in the league? 11?
Oh, man, it was at least 10.
Wow.
So like I try to tell guys all the time and try to introduce them to the product that, you know, you need to learn what you're depleting out of your body. You know, everybody wants to go to the drugs and doing the surgery and different stuff like that. But if you're not attacking what's causing the problems, then, I mean, you're defeating the purpose.
Exactly. Breast cancer is exploding. It's always find the cure. How about we find out why it's exploding? You know, same thing with sports. Why do so many marathon runners end up having heart attacks later? Well, it turns out they've depleted all their minerals. As Doc Wallach was saying, Gatorade and the stuff they push has got like 2 or 3 minerals in it. This has got, you know, 90, the mighty 90 minerals and vitamins. It's just incredible. The entire longevity line. Folks can go to InfoWarsHealth.com to find out more, or they can also go Rebound4Energy.com to learn about that product specifically and then go get discounts and free shipping if you sign up as a distributor and get auto ship at InfoWarsHealth.com or InfoWarsTeam.com. Theo, this is such an amazing story because I only promote what I believe in. And I started, you know, sure, about 2 years ago, everybody's telling me this is great. And I've never been a vitamin or mineral taker. I'd gotten like 70 pounds overweight. That's embarrassing to say. Talk radio, hadn't worked out in years. turning, and I've lost 40-something pounds. Aaron Dykes, and it's not even advertised as weight loss, it's just you're always hungry because there's no minerals or vitamins in it. As soon as Aaron got on this stuff, he lost 92 pounds. In fact, guys, you can go show that video on screen while folks are watching. Or go to InfoWarsHealth.com, folks. You can see the full Aaron video. But, I mean, it is miraculous how you're not as hungry anymore once you drink things like Beyond Tangy Tangerine or Rebound. It's incredible.
Yeah, it is. I mean, like I say, all of them are great products. And, you know, I love to hear the stories. I love to hear people talk to me about, you know, them being on cancer and taking the chemo and energy is just bad. And the only thing that can help them to be able to get up and move is drinking that Rebound. I mean, I love to hear stories like that.
Well, tell us, I mean, how many of the other NBA people have you turned on to this? I mean, are they getting similar results?
I've turned guys on. I've turned a lot of guys on to it. You know, it's a matter of being a diligent student.
I was selling it and didn't really get on it for about a year.
Right.
I mean,
right.
I believed in it and saw results. Okay, here's a great thing. But I did when I really started seeing, incredible results. I mean, it really is amazing.
Yeah, just say the ones that used it were very impressed. On how much energy and how it helped them sustain their energy and the product itself, just how healthy the product was as far as the amount of minerals and vitamins that it has within the product, and it was a natural product. They were very impressed with that. And also, the guys that used it also had pretty long careers where they were pretty much in bad shapes too, because most of the time people don't really turn to this until it's a do or die situation.
What about the nutritionist? I mean, I notice now, Theo, when I go to like Whole Foods or Central Market, the big nicer grocery stores, suddenly there's other products kind of touting the same thing. But I notice they don't have the Mighty 90 like Doc Wallach's products and Rebound and others have it. And I mean, the original now being copied, but still the best.
Yes, sir.
Wow. What does your wife think of this? I mean, if it gave you 10 more years in the NBA, that's a lot of moolah.
Oh yeah, she loving it. She enjoying the benefits.
Wow, it's amazing. Well, I tell you, I take Rebound before I go into the gym, and my only issue is I'm already pretty wound up, and when you get all the things that are in this, it just absolutely turbocharges you. But I particularly like the liquid version. What's your favorite, the powder or the liquid?
Yeah, I like the powder. I like the citrus punch, because especially while I was playing, because I'm moving around, so I got used to doing the powder a lot easier, to carry and not have to worry about spilling.
Oh, yeah, it's smaller. And yeah, that's a good point.
And they have the packs. Small individual package.
Absolutely. Theo Ratliff is our guest. Folks, Big Pharma does not want you to know about this. This is a real revolution. We've got him for three more segments or 30 minutes, Theo Ratliff. And I'm not even somebody that has time over the years to watch sports, but even I know who he is. One of the top blockers in NBA history, star at the Los Angeles Lakers. The list goes on and on. He also is the owner of the Rome Gladiators. And he also has a degree in communications from the University of Wyoming. And they developed the proprietary Rebound because he was such a fan of longevity and chalks up 10 more years in the league to it. Now, we have Dr. Wallach. And in between Theo getting all excited, me getting excited, the doc sitting over there. But, folks, I only get excited about stuff I'm excited about. I sound like a carnival barker here. And that's not the best way to pitch something. But I am here promoting this because it really does work. People that have Alzheimer's, we've seen go on this and get their memory back, like Ted Anderson's dad. And then the doctor says, go off of it. You're not allowed to have vitamin K or leafy vegetables. And his dad has his skin just rotting off with scurvy, basically. And Ted wants the story told. The doctor told his wife, Ted's dad, hey, don't let him have this. Don't let him have Beyond Tangy Tangerine stuff. So he didn't, and now he doesn't know who he is again. I mean, I hate to use that, but it's the truth. I mean, The medical, Dr. Wallach, how many of the medical doctors know this, and how many are just compartmentalized idiots? We know Big Pharma knows it.
Well, you're exactly right, Alex. The crime is that all the medical doctors know this, but they're profit-driven, and there's no law requiring a doctor to cure you, and there's a cure available. And so they choose to manage symptoms. For instance, when you have diabetes, if they were to make you an ex-diabetic to cure you, and they can do this, oh, say in 4 weeks, you're able to wean off your medication, go back to normal life, be an ex-diabetic in 4 weeks, the doctor will make $300 in office calls. But if he manages your diabetes for 25 years, he'll make $750,000. So they always go for the management of the disease rather than just getting rid of it. There's no money in it for getting rid of it. And they're a protected monopoly. They have absolutely no competitors. The government protects them.
I want to talk about this more when we come back, but sure. This is a short segment, long segment coming up. I mean, you've known Theo a lot longer than I have. I've just seen him on TV and I'm talking to him here for the first time. What should I be asking Theo right now? Or Theo, jump in here because I'll run over you.
Well, basically, we need to be asking Theo the reason why these other athletes didn't pick up on it, because the average lifespan, when you take all professional athletes, is 62. Professional football players, the average lifespan is 51. That was just a recent study, 51. It's absolutely tragic because they're all dying early because they're sweating out their nutrients and not replacing them.
Yeah, Theo, I mean, people are really dumb when people even I know this works. And they're like, oh, I don't need vitamins and minerals.
Right. It's just a hard sell. It shouldn't be hard, but it's hard. I think a lot of it is due to a lot of the other products that don't do what it says it is supposed to do. The products that are not the quality of a longevity, I think has a lot to do with it. And I think a lot of it just has to do with people are going to listen to whatever their doctors tell them to do.
No, that's it. The MDs are God.
Right.
I mean, Ted Anderson's told the story. His dad didn't know who he was. His dad in 6 months came back. Right. I mean, knew who he was. The wounds were healing. What are those wounds that the old people get? I mean, isn't that pretty much scurvy, Dr. Wallach?
It certainly could be scurvy. It could be circulation problems. It could be actually gluten intolerance, where they eat too much wheat, barley, rye, and oats, and their skin will actually dry up and get ulcerated, and they get eczema and dermatitis. And so there's multiple causes of that. But if you straighten up your diet, you take the 90 essential nutrients, that all goes away.
All right, we'll stay there. We're going to come back, and I'm going to hand it over to you, Doc, because I know you've got the questions for Theo. You guys have known each other for 11 years. I want to talk about this when we come back. Amazing to have Theo Ratliff. Just retired, got an extra 10 years thanks to longevity. Amazing. I want people to find out about this. InfoWarsHealth.com. Well, he just retired. He got an extra 10 years thanks to finding the secret of full-spectrum vitamins and minerals and trace elements. Theo Ratliff, even a sports moron like me who doesn't even hardly follow it because I'm always focused on researching the New World Order, knows what Theo Ratliff is. He's an American former professional basketball player, just retired, who last played with the NBA's Los Angeles Lakers, and he's listed as one of the all-time greatest blockers, amongst other things. His amazing websites are futurephenom.com and reboundforenergy.com. We have those linked at InfoWarsHealth.com. And he joins us right now. He also owns the Rome Gladiators, and he's on with us with Dr. Wallach. Dr. Wallach, I want to ask you this question. Why is exercise without supplementation suicide, in your words? And then I want you, for the remaining 20 minutes we have left with Theo here, to take it away with, I want you to interview him, just because I know you guys have known each other for so long, and I know how much Theo admires the work you've done. So do I. I want people to realize you're the guy that's beaten the Food and Drug Administration repeatedly in court, or we'd have Codex Alimentarius here banning us having access to vitamin minerals. I mean, I don't know if people realize who we're on the air with right now and just how much you've done for liberty, buddy, because I'm all about liberty. And this health issue is something we can take control of. The system wants us sick. That's what MD Rockefeller Medicine is all about.
Well, thank you for the kind words, Alec. Really appreciate that. And you're certainly right. You're my hero because you're on the people that need to be watched, and we appreciate that. Well, we did actually make a CD based on Theo's stories called Dead Athletes Don't Lie. And this goes on to the statement you mentioned, exercise without supplementation is suicide. And that's because you do sweat out nutrients, in great amounts when you sweat. Whether you're exercising, you're a roofer, you're working in a steel factory, you're digging trenches, throwing bales of hay, if you're sweating out whatever nutrients you have floating around in your blood. If you have 90 essential nutrients, which most people don't unless they're supplementing with longevity products, you're sweating out 90 essential nutrients, not just water. If you are only consuming, say, 70 nutrients, you're sweating out all 70 nutrients. You're drinking water, your nutrient levels go down. If you're drinking Gatorade, you're 88 short. If you're drinking Rebound, you're getting all 100 nutrients in Rebound, including all the essential nutrients you need. And so it's imperative, if you're going to sweat, you have to supplement properly and Rebound as part of the system to replace not only the fluid you're losing, but also the nutrients. We have Olympic athletes. Delisha Jones, who Theo knows very well, great lady, a basketball player. She has won 4 gold medals in Olympics. She's been with us for 12 years, even a year before we started with Theo. And she attributes her 4 gold medals to the Healthy Start Packs, the extra glucogel to support and promote maintenance repair of her joints, ligaments, tendons, connective tissue, cartilage. And also she loves the Rebound. And I think she kind of likes looking at Theo's picture, too. She's a great lady.
Well, listen to this. I want to break this down for Theo because I got one question. I kind of interrupted him when he brought this up, and I want you to ask some quick questions and spend some time with Theo while we've got him here. Theo, you started getting into your grandmother, and, you know, folks in the old days knew that you needed minerals. Veterinarians like Dr. Wallach, I mean, I've worked for a large animal vet. It's all about minerals. That's what, you know, mineral feeds, mineral blocks. But, I mean, what were you trying to say about your grandma, and that's why this stuff made sense to you?
Well, I mean, just from back in the day, Dr. Wallach always tell a great story about, you know, how he got into the minerals on the farm with his father and being on the farm and raising the cattle and different things of that nature and using the minerals. And back in the day, you know, my grandmother, when we got sick or certain things happened, Collivore was always our remedy, which is, you know, vitamin E. You know, that was always a big thing. And then, you know, I'm from a town called Demopolis, Alabama. So we had the clay. You know, the clay was a big thing.
See, I didn't even know you were going to say that. But I said clay because folks in East Texas know eat the certain clay because it's got the minerals in it.
Right. And just different things that of that nature. And, you know, back then our ground was so rich in nutrients at the time, growing stuff in the garden and different things of that nature. So it made sense, you know, when he started talking about the plant-derived minerals and the absorption in your body. It's a natural state.
It's funny that the old-timers knew all this, because when my dad was sick as a kid, his nanny would try to give him clay and he'd eat it. And at first my grandma was like, hey, that's not good, but he would actually get better when she gave him that and other things. And right. It turns out she knew what she was doing.
Yeah, it's funny how it works like that. They know what they're talking about.
Dr. Wallach, what's in the clay versus what's in, I mean, that's the plant-derived minerals, isn't it?
Well, the plant-derived minerals are actually a compost. It's actually plants, a clay or mineral silt from fine particles off of rocks. And you're both getting close to the story. And if I may, I'll ask both of you this question. What did your grandma and grandpa do with the wood ashes from their wood stove every morning? Where did they go?
It went in the garden.
In the garden,
exactly. Well, wood ashes are not really ashes. Wood ashes are the minerals that are left when you burn wood for fuel. And you put these wood ashes, a.k.a. plant minerals, into the garden, the squash and the sweet potatoes and the onions and the pumpkins and the corn and tomatoes and beans and peas would suck up those minerals. You ate those vegetables and grains, and you got your minerals in that fashion. Well, at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, Monday, September 4th, 1882, Thomas Edison pulled the switch on the first commercial electric generating plant on Pearl Street in New York City. And 5 years later, just about everybody had an electric stove or propane stove or a natural gas stove, and where did you get your minerals? Well, nobody was putting wood ashes into the garden anymore. We began to break down, and that's where the problem came. And, of course, when Theo moved away from the farm living with grandma and great-grandma and his mom, he didn't have access to foods grown and all those minerals from the wood ashes going into the garden every day. He came to the cities where the universities were, and they got food grown from the big farms where they had chemical fertilizer rather than wood ashes.
With two minerals in it.
Two or three. Plants only need three. Human beings need 60. So if you're eating a pretty good slice of organically grown multigrain bread baked with love by the pastor's wife in church on Sunday, you're 57 short.
And then you've got the trace elements. How important are... Well, you asked the questions. Theo's sitting here, and we're ranting and raving, Doc. We can do that any day. Theo, are there points you want to make?
Well, the trace elements, Theo's very familiar with them. The sudden deaths that occur in famous athletes like Reggie Lewis died of a cardiomyopathy, a heart attack. And of course, these kids, there's somewhere around 75,000 to 100,000 young Americans under the age of 30 drop dead suddenly each year while they're exercising because they sweat out a particular trace element called selenium. A selenium deficiency alone causes hypertrophic cardiomyopathy, heart disease, which is the most common cause of sudden death.
That happened when I was 8 years old playing football. The star running back just fell over dead of a heart attack, and they did the autopsy. He didn't have any heart defects, and they said, we don't know why he died.
Well, he died of a selenium deficiency, and the reason why they say they don't know, every medical examiner should take a course in chemical nutritional deficiencies that cause sudden death. They don't know anything about that, and as a result, this problem is perpetuated. Now, I actually went to China and did 1,200 autopsies on kids under the age of 10 in Qishan province in China that died of this cardiomyopathy heart disease. It's published in an international journal.
It's amazing. Theo, give us your take on the trace minerals.
Not to cut you off, Doc. A lot of the guys in the league tend to have heart issues after they're done. And, you know, from being a part of longevity and speaking with Dr. Wallach and speaking to some of the professionals on the selenium, you know, if you're taking the selenium, then those things go away. And like I said, when you're playing, you're sweating out your nutrients, you're sweating out your minerals, you're breaking down your calcium in your body. So you have so many different diseases and so many different things that mineral deficiencies create diseases from that if you don't put it in, then everything starts to break down.
But if the doctors tell you, they won't get to chop you up and make money.
Right. It pains me to see some of these retired guys that I see now, you know, being retired. I see a lot more of the guys and their bodies are broken down and knee replacements, heel replacements, shoulder. I mean, it goes on and on and on. And as they continue to put those chemicals in their body, they steady breaking down their insides and everything else through all the drugs and different stuff that they have to take. And I try to explain to a lot of the guys that you got to get your body, get it back healthy with putting the proper minerals that can, the plant-derived minerals from the longevity to be able to build your body back. And it can happen even no matter what age you are. It can still happen for you.
It's been miraculous. My mother's run triathlons for a long time, and she had just hit a wall. And now she says it's like 15 years ago. She lost weight. Her muscles got soft again. I mean, my mother is not a media person, and she's ready to go on air and talk about what longevity's done for her. It's that powerful.
That's beautiful. That's a beautiful thing, man.
But like you said, Theo, it's frustrating when people've heard all these other fake claims, then they think everything's bull, I guess.
Right, right. And I think that's what you're fighting. Besides just the doctors and the medicine, you know, them masking pain, you know, giving it the steroids and different things, shooting people up all the time, letting it go away for a couple of weeks, and then it comes back on them, and then they got to do it again. I mean, that's a big issue.
It is. So they, again, folks, notice they never want to find that why we're all getting autism or neurological disorders or cancer exploding or diabetes. It's always... Let's find a cure. Let's find a cure. It's like not asking why people are getting shot in the head. Let's find a cure to being shot in the head. No, let's find out why so many people are getting shot in the head. And they know that that's why the UN and others don't want you to have vitamins and minerals. They want to shut this down. Well, I tell you, I could go all day with Theo Ratliff and, of course, Dr. Joel Wallach. We've only got like 6 minutes left in this short segment. I should also add, if you want to get Rebound, Beyond Tangy Tangerine, Polymburst, but when it comes to sports drinks, you can't beat it with the Rebound FX. I like the berry liquid. He likes the citrus punch. The point is it's awesome. It's all available at InfoWarsHealth.com. Or you can give members of the InfoWars team a call, and they can sign you up as a distributor to get discounts, also for auto ship to get free shipping at InfoWarsHealth.com or InfoWarsTeam.com, 877-551-1301. That's 877-551-1301 if you've got any questions or need help getting signed up for auto ship or to be a distributor or preferred customer. There's a lot of benefits there. You can find it at InfoWarsTeam.com. Theo, we're going to let you go here at the break. I'm going to come back with a few minutes just with Wallet because I know he's chomping at the bit to talk about things. But I've been asking a lot of questions. What else would you like to tell people about longevity, about Rebound, about how big a deal it is? Because people know me. I don't just sit here and harp and harp and harp on things that I'm pitching. Sure, we make money out of this, but I make money out of things I believe in that fight the tyranny, fight the corrupt medical system. I sleep really good at night promoting this, and that's why it's getting so big. I mean, longevity overall is up 30% just from me promoting it in the last year because people are really having the effect. It's not just hype. No, it's real.
Well, I just want to say that we appreciate you. We appreciate what you do and what you've done, you know, for longevity and for the Rebound product. It's been great getting the word out to people about this great product. And, you know, we just want you to keep on doing your thing and keep letting people know, opening people's eyes up to what's really going on as far as out there with their health. And I also wanted to say that the kids, I mean, I do a lot of things with kids. I have an activity center back home, Theo Ratliff Foundation back home. I have an activity center, work with a lot of kids. And I always do a camp of like 300 or so kids each year for free for the kids, and I bring this product, and the kids love it, you know, and it's in my activity center. They love it. My kids love it. I don't let them do sports or play anything or do anything without taking minerals, you know, and that's the key. If you get them early, my five-year-olds, they love it. When they see me drink, hey, Daddy, I need some of that Rebound. Give me some of that Rebound. You know? And they already think they LeBron James and D Wade, so they're taking it. They take the kids toddy, and take those products that are made for kids also. So, it's something that once you start them early and it becomes their routine and they know about health and they know why they're taking it, it just becomes like clockwork. You know, it becomes easy as just picking up a pencil and writing every day. So I always want to let that out there is that, you know, it's definitely a big thing that starts with the kids. And we always want to bring the kids into something that's going to make them great, not just physically, but also mentally at the same time.
Well, I was about to say, I felt major mental changes once I got on this. More energy, better thought processes. Yes. More aggressive because I've always been an aggressive person. I mean, did you see any mental changes once you got on longevity?
Oh, yes, definitely. I mean, you know, like with us, you know, one of the things that a major thing with mineral deficiency is with the athlete is sleeping. You know, if I sit and I try to read a book or try to read my emails or something, I end up falling asleep, you know, back when I first, before I got on the product. But now that I've been on the product, I can sit and I can concentrate. I sit down and read a book.
I was about to say that's a side effect, even though Beyond Tangy Tangerine has no green tea extract, no stimulant. My mother and I, we've all noticed, if you take it at night, you're hungry at 10, you drink it, you're not hungry anymore. Problem is, you're not going to sleep.
Right. You're going to be very active.
Yeah, because drugs wish that they were food. They wish they were minerals and vitamins. Drugs try to... it's just amazing. It's amazing that the system knows this. Big Pharma's out of business if this word gets out there.
Oh, yeah. It's a great thing, but it'll be a lot more healthier people. That's the whole goal.
Well, we're getting the word out to a lot of professional athletes right now. They need to all try Rebound. And you know what, athletes, if you try and it doesn't have an effect, you can call in. We don't screen the calls and tell me I'm a liar. But I know that's not going to happen because longevity has developed the formula. They are the trailblazers, InfoWarsHealth.com. And you can also visit Theo's excellent websites, reboundforenergy.com, futurephenom.com. And he also has some other sites you can find there on that site as well. But go to InfoWarsHealth.com and see the Aaron Dykes testimonial of before and afters. You can see my before and afters. I've still got some weight to lose, but I've lost over 40 pounds, and it's not even advertised as weight loss. Wow, well, one of the top people in the NBA. Theo, I'm sorry, go ahead, sir.
I said keep on losing that weight.
All right, God bless you. Theo, thank you so much.
We're on the march. The Empire's.
All right, I'm going to spend five more minutes with Doc Wallach and then move on to the news that we haven't gotten to and some of the top stories here. But we just spent an hour on this because, yeah, longevity, InfoWarsHealth.com, the discounts there, it helps fund our news organization. We're not like George Soros that gets banker bailout money and then uses it to fund anti-America groups and anti-liberty groups. Or MSNBC, they got, what was it, $500 million of stimulus money to give million-dollar raises to Rachel Maddow. We're here promoting and selling things that we believe in, that we use, whether it's ProPure discounted at InfoWars.com or whether it's the longevity products discounted there at InfoWarsHealth.com. But the revolution of minerals itself, I wanted to spring this on Dr. Wallach. My dad, who I think I am going to get in studio about a bunch of issues, he's a dentist, oral surgeon. He goes down, he volunteers for a big charity. And once a year, he goes to Belize, or he goes to Mexico, or he goes to Central America. For the first time, he went to Paraguay earlier this year for a couple weeks. A piece of dynamite, the news said a hand grenade, it was a piece of dynamite, got thrown at a soccer game the one day they had off, like one of the last days. And they go, my dad saw the guy throw the dynamite. He grew up on a farm. He knew dynamite. He used to blow stumps up, and it blew up some of the umpires and people. My dad saw that. He's like, he got back and said, yeah, I saw this. And I went and looked it up, and there it was. But the point is, he was down in Paraguay, and the Amish are the only people holding the country up. They went into the rocky desert north, most of it's jungle, but in the north, a couple hundred years ago when they got driven out of Russia and other areas. And so they went there, and they developed it, and now they produce more than half the food in the country. And my dad has all the names, but there's this one head Amish guy who's basically industrializing the whole country for people now. You think of them as not being industrial, but, just basic, food, water, aquifers, all this stuff that the Amish know. And it's one of the biggest Amish colonies down there. And my dad had all the literature and stuff. It was in Spanish. He can read Spanish. I can't. But he was explaining that they used to have all these street kids there, and they have them all over Latin America, who are basically have different disorders, mentally retarded, but not genetically. They don't have extra chromosomes or chromosomal problems. They just have all sorts of mental problems. They're stunted. And it was very simple. There's no nutrition. The few orphanages that give them beans and rice, they're not getting what they need. The Amish have started giving in little candies minerals. And basically, I was looking at it, it's close to longevity. What they've come up with down there, they just give the little kids, the Mennonites do, and the Amish, and the UN's trying to shut them down and hates them because they want to deindustrialize it. But the point is, that's exactly what's going on. And so now the Amish are helping people with incredible results because the kids will eat the candies. And now it's eradicating all these different disorders. Just amazing that this knowledge is starting to be discovered by others, Dr. Wallach.
Well, it's a good thing, Alex. Certainly is the basic need of all vertebrates, whether you're a turtle or an elephant or a human being. We all need the 90 essential nutrients, and this is a worldwide thing. And the top 20 longevity cultures around the world are found all over the place, including Central America and South America. And it's by dumb luck, they live in a place that has lots of minerals in the soil, and the wood they burn, the trees suck up the minerals, and they put the wood ashes in the gardens. Well, these are relatively small areas. We can't get 7 billion people from the entire world populations to move into those places. So we have to create the same environment wherever we are, and we can do this by supplementation. We can add 25 to 50 healthful years to our life. We can take a broken-down professional athlete like Theo, who's become just an icon in professional athletics, to add 10 years to his professional playing life just by taking a supplement. I mean, you think about that. What if you can add 10 years to everybody's life in America in a healthful way? I believe we can do that. And this is a worldwide problem. And it's something that through your help, and you're one of our heroes, certainly, getting this message out, because we can save America through your help financially and certainly health-wise. And I don't mind if the doctors go out of business, so we really don't need them. They have legislated themselves into a certain position where they have a...
Well, look at what police states they are. I mean, marijuana has shown it has no bad effects on fetuses, but they'll tell women, take Prozac, take all these drugs that we know attack them, take vaccines. Until 4 years ago, all medical doctors, all inserts said, don't give pregnant women vaccines. It causes autoimmune problems. It causes miscarriages. Now they're pushing it. And I see the stories rolling in of professional women who aren't even pot smokers going in. They don't tell you they're blood testing you for drugs. Boom, THC, they come take your baby. They don't tell you these hospitals are prisons now. They're now making the healthcare providers take vaccines. These, it happened in Russia, it happened in Nazi Germany, it happened in Soviet China, or communist China, that the medical system is a tyranny. It's great if your leg's broken. It does some good. But that's kind of like the mafia does some good. Yeah, but they also do a lot more bad.
Exactly. Well, I'll tell you, there was a recent one. Of course, you know Neil Armstrong died. He was actually killed by a doctor. He didn't die of a heart attack. He had his physical. And he was 82 years old, and they said, you know, you're pretty strong, Neil, for 82 years old, but you got this little blockage in your artery. Why don't you let us do a bypass before you have a heart attack? You know, if you have a heart attack, you're in a crisis, you might die. But now you're healthy. Now's the time to let us do a bypass. And they did a bypass on him, and he died of a blood clot as a result of that surgery. These doctors killed Neil Armstrong. They don't get an investigation. They don't get a urine test to see if they were drunk. They don't get a urine test to see if they're on drugs. You don't even know what the doctor's name that killed Neil Armstrong.
Well, I know this. One of my dad's really good friends is a former Olympic swimmer and a very successful businessman. I'm not going to get into the whole story, even though I'm not saying the guy's name. I probably shouldn't tell the story. But he sued and successfully won the medical doctor. They talked him into getting two stents. And they put in like 12 or something just because the doctor made more money. And it turned out this so-called, you know, well-to-do doctor was doing this to a bunch of people. And it's now been run out of business here in Austin. But the point is, that's incredible that he didn't need probably even the two stents, but he went in and did it. And then they and the guy to make more money just put a whole bunch in there and basically has really hurt this guy's lifespan.
Exactly. And of course, that's why the Medicare cost in hospices has gone up 70% in 1 year, because when grandma's in hospice, unconscious, in a coma, they'll do a hysterectomy on her, a double mastectomy, double hip replacement, double knee replacement, and make $200,000 on her, getting all the money out of her Medicare fund before she dies, because they have the right to do that.
Some well-known Austinites that are good friends of mine, if I said their name, everybody in Austin knows who I'm talking about. They live out on Lake Austin, and a rattlesnake, she went out to take the trash out, and a little baby rattlesnake, which is the worst because they pump all their venom, bit her. And she felt fine, but they said, well, let's go to the hospital. Now, they sell snake venom in Arizona in the stores for $20. Because they had top flight insurance, their bill was $300,000+ for 2 days in the hospital. Just pure robbery. And the insurance company challenged it and got it down to $100,000. I mean, all they did was put an IV in her with anti-venom, $100,000. I mean, how do they get away with this?
Because of insurance. If there was no insurance, Alex, nobody would tolerate that kind of stuff. Because there's insurance, they have no competition, so there's no other options, people feel. The cost of health care has just been driven up terribly, and doctors can kill with impunity. 15 million people in America are killed, injured, infected in the doctor's workplace every year. They do not even get an OSHA ticket. Nobody would fly commercial airlines if they knew that commercial airlines killed, injured, infected 15 million of their passengers every year. But because of insurance, people will say, well, insurance pays for it. Let's just go to the doctor. And of course, if they do what you and I suggest to them, we'll add 25 to 50 healthful years of their life, and they'll be protected from, what should I say, an unnecessary death like Neil Armstrong. Like
how much more money did Theo Ratliff in the NBA make in the 10 years that he was able to continue because of just getting basic minerals?
It was over $40 million. Probably cost him $300 a month and he made over $40 million as a result of his extra 10 years.
Well, that's my only problem is Theo was talking about getting the kids to do it when they're young. I've got my kids asking for the essential fatty acids, your proprietary blend, asking for the Beyond Tangy Tangerine, asking for these things because they've gotten on it. And my wife's always been putting them on vitamins and minerals, but now we've shifted over to yours because it is the best blends. But I have never done it in my life, so I'll make myself for a few days do it and then quit and then remember to do it. Aaron, religiously committed and looks like Superman back there. So, I mean, I've had incredible effects, but I just need to somehow get myself in the regimen because when I do it, then I'm not hungry and I feel even better and then I can go forward. But I just am in such a habit of not pill popping.
Okay, well, here's what I do, because I'm on the road all the time. You can see where I could say, well, I'm busy, I didn't bring enough with me. I actually bring a three-month supply with me, even though I'm going to be on the road only for 4 weeks. I also build two bottles a day with all my supplements in each bottle. I kind of pre-fill them while I'm watching TV at night, looking at the news. I'll fill all my bottles with all the various supplements, the selenium, the Ocean's Gold.
That's the issue, is there's all these bottles and I'm not hauling them around. That's what it is.
And so what I do is instead of taking 20 bottles, I'll just take one bottle with me that I've already pre-filled with all the stuff. And I do that two bottles a day for about 2 weeks. I pre-make them. And when I get down to the last couple bottles, I'll pre-make my 2 weeks again. And so I just grab the bottles. I bring my liquids with me. And I do that twice a day. I've been doing it religiously for 64 years.
And by the way, tell folks how old you are.
I'm 73. And I haven't been to a medical doctor with me being the patient for 64 years.
Yeah, by the way, the Skype is not the best representation of you. You look like you're about, I don't know, 60, 62, 65 in the Skype. In person, on stage, you look like you could be 60 years old, 59 years old. And I mean, physically, you're in such good shape is the amazing thing.
Yeah, well, thank you. Yeah, nobody's going to steal an airplane with you or I on it, Alex, I'll tell you. And this is actually a testament to these nutrients. The human body does not age based on chronological time. The human body ages based on the presence of or lack of nutrients. And if you take your nutrients, you can be chronologically 100 and biologically 30.
Well, that's what Ray Kurzweil, the top globalist, says. Have you noticed Ray Kurzweil is saying what you're saying and basically takes a regimen that looks like you developed it?
Yes, exactly. These people are on top of it because they're worldly. They've been around. They see who is successful in health and who isn't. And the people who are successful in health and longevity, just like these long-lived cultures, they have 100.
Well, Kurzweil says he cured himself of diabetes with a nutrient-dense thing similar to longevity.
Oh, absolutely. I can't use the cure word technically, but I can make you an ex-diabetic in 2 to 14 days. I did this with a top medical laboratory owner, a guy by the name of Murphy. This guy here, Jerry Murphy, had terrible advanced diabetes. He services 7,000 hospitals a day, has access to the best endocrinologist, the best cutting-edge information on diabetes. He was failing. Everything was going downhill. And just a couple of months, I was able to get him off his medication. His A1C hemoglobin went from about 8 down to 4.3. His blood sugar went from 171 with medication down to 71 without medication.
I mean, look how it's exploded. What do people get at InfoWarsHealth.com that from your research has had incredible effects on type 2 diabetes?
Oh, well, type 2 diabetes, I mean, we actually, I would say, because of our world connections now, 1,000 people a day are being weaned off of their medication and are ex-diabetics.
Amazing. And what do they want to get at InfoWarsHealth.com? What's the cocktail?
Well, the cocktail is the Healthy Start Pack and the Sweet Ease. We also call it the Healthy Blood Sugar Pack. It could be the Healthy Blood Sugar Pack or the Healthy Start Pack and the Sweet Ease.
And we call the starter pack Alex Pack, discounted at InfoWarsHealth.com. Well, listen, I'm going to hit some final news. Doc, I tell you, this is revolutionary what you're doing. And if people just take the challenge and try it for themselves, they're going to, with something just like a Rebound or Beyond Tangy Tangerine or the Polymers Plus, if they just try it, I think they're really going to be amazed and understand why I'm hyping this up so much. Because, again, folks, cancer, diabetes, neurological disorders, it's all exploding because of the GMOs, the bisphenol A, all this stuff that they're putting into us. But when you get real rare earth minerals that have the full spectrum, and are really what was originally, you know, in the dirt, because we have these habilitated soils. When you get it from the soils that still have it, it is amazing. Go watch the video with Aaron Dykes to see what we're talking about at InfoWarsHealth.com or call 877-551-1301. Thank you so much, Dr. Wallach, for breaking all this down for us today.
Well, thank you, Alex. You're a great host. You're a great hero of America. And together, I think you and I can save America. God bless you.
Well, God bless you. There goes Dr. Wallach. And I was just going to spend 30 minutes with those guys. I spent like an hour and 20 minutes with them because I get really excited. You know, there's all this stuff going on in the world, all this craziness. But if we can expose why we're getting so sick, how it's engineered, it just mitigates so much of it. I mean, the effects are just absolutely nothing less than miraculous is the only word to describe it. And when you purchase the products, it funds the operation, the reporters, everything we do. Again, we're listener-supported, InfoWarsTeam.com or InfoWarsHealth.com or 877-551-1301. They're not operators standing by. They're distributors for InfoWars. They're part of our team. There, when you call that number, they can answer all of your questions. Okay, I already covered a lot of this, but I didn't cover a lot of it. So let me, in this short time we have left before we go to break, when we come back, get into all this. Look at this. How China and U.S. secretly tested genetically modified golden rice on children. Chinese health authorities are investigating allegations that genetically modified rice has been tested on Chinese children as part of a research project backed by the U.S. Department of Agriculture. And it just goes into what they did, 6 and 8 years old. Well, I mean, what about the U.S. government paid Israel to irradiate 110,000 of their kids in the ringworm project? Here's a story at InfoWars.com, and it links right through to the news over in Japan. Fukushima fish have 258 times safe levels of radiation. And we now learn within 3 months of the blow-up, tuna caught off San Diego had high levels of radiation, and the government kept that secret and just let you eat it. Amazing to have that news. Speaking of China, I've got it here in my stack. I don't know if I'll find it in time. Where, again, Al Gore's company, he's on the board, is helping them do test and forced abortions at the Apple plants in China. I mean, I've said I know Apple tracks and traces you, and they've got a good pitch and good products, but I mean, it's just an evil company. But they're all evil. But Apple is so much more evil. It's like they're so evil, and they tell you there are these great liberals. I mean, let me tell you something, folks. If I was on the board of Apple, there wouldn't be one-child abortions going on at the factory or suicide nets, and people would work 8 hours a day, or if they wanted bonuses and we needed, they could voluntarily work for more. And here's the thing. Almost nothing goes into manufacturing these. I've seen the numbers. It's pure evil greed. Pure evil greed for a few dollars per iPhone. Those people can be treated like humans. And it's not a free market. They use a communist system to do it. Al Gore is a maggot of hell. Al Gore, you murderer. You are a murdering scumbag. Ugh. And by the way, I really do think Al Gore is a murderer. He backed the bombing of Serbia, backing al-Qaeda. Bombing their country with DU. I don't have a dog in the fight, Serb, Croat, Muslim. It's just the facts of the facts. He has backed policies at the Foxconn factory where people are committing suicide mass. He's just a pig. And it's time to call that maggot slave factory running piece of trash out. Who wants to run around and talk about how he's so liberal all day and wants to come into towns where I live, like Austin, and sit there and push Agenda 21 to pay that fat hog more of my money and your money. I'm sick of these people. It's time to call them out for what they are. Look at this, London Telegraph. Notice how they spin this. Do you catch this? Chinese man was unlawfully sent to re-education through labor camp. And they go on to say, oh, it's not that we send millions to re-education camps. That's wrong. This guy was wrongfully sent. London Telegraph today. Here's the article. A Chinese man who served 2 years in a re-education through labor, what's in the new army manuals? Re-education through labor camp is entitled to compensation after a local panel ruled he was unlawfully sent there, according to his lawyer. I guarantee you, folks, if they came out and said, we're going to start sending people to re-education camps who are politically incorrect, people would line up and support it just to be politically correct. And bye-bye, Alex, go into the slave camp. This will teach you. I'm telling you, this is who these... I had the Zeitgeist creator guy on one time, and I said, well, what'll happen if I don't want... He goes, well, you'll be sent for re-education. And then years later, I'm like, hey, come back on the show. He goes, you've got to retract that. I never said that. Here's the video. And I went and looked at it, and there he was saying it. Again, I'm not getting a fight with the zeitgeist people, but come on, folks. Re-education camps, I don't want to go live in the plastic city. And here's that article on the New American Magazine. Apple Corps allows forced one-child pregnancy screening of its employees in China. Every month, they're at the medical tyranny at the Apple plant. Here it is. LifeSite News recently reported the story of Chen Zhongqing, a dissident who escaped from China as a shining spotlight on Apple Corporation, whose employees at factories in China are compelled to undergo monthly pregnancy tests. Yeah, under Agenda 21, you live in a building and the factory's under it, and then you're under all this medical tyranny. We're already here. They're already shooting our kids up with vaccines without parental consent. They're already arresting mothers who have kids playing in the cul-de-sac or in their backyard, watching them. My kids, when I lived in the town, played in the cul-de-sac at the end of the street, and I wasn't watching them. Come arrest me, you nutcases, you control freaks. Here's AP. British school puts cameras in bathrooms and lockers, in the bathroom stalls. I saw stories 12 years ago in Tennessee and in, what was it, Missouri, Sacramento, California. There was one case in Tennessee where the visiting school for, what was it, seventh grade girls basketball. You can pull this up. They came, and they were in the showers and noticed cameras and ran out screaming, and the parents all got upset and called the cops. And they were like, wait, it's all right. We watch people in the showers here. Again, it's body snatcher level what we end up putting up with in this country. And they reported, like, what's the big deal? People are concerned there's cameras in the bathroom stalls. It's for your safety, and that's in England. We've had this for a long time. It's going in all over the place. And now new DARPA robot can autonomously track and kill people. That's at Infowars.com. Got a lot of other news up there right now. Look, we need to get upset. We need to get out of our comfort zone, out of our normalcy bias, and realize, hey, that guy we thought was crazy named Alex Jones, he wasn't crazy. He was freaked out. Sure, he was aggressive enough to not put up with it, but folks, this stuff's all real, okay? We got to say no to it or it's going to get 100 times worse.